Wow.
Wait, go back. Because you fucking said,
I asked if you know how to do it.
You know how to do it.
I didn't say do it.
Shit. Wait, no, go back. Fade?
I don't know. I can't hear. I'll have to watch it later. It wasn't
good. Here? You should have been looking at it.
Well, yeah, it looks nice.
You looked away right when I, after all that fucking shit of transitioning, you looked away when I clicked the button.
Does the audio crossfade? That's what I really want to know.
Crossfade?
Yeah, crossfade.
What?
One fades out and the other one fades in.
Crossfade?
That's a term. That's an editing term. I'm pretty sure you know this. Before the show starts.
You better watch it, Vito.
Yeah, I'm in a lot of trouble.
I'll criticize you.
And I'm then in a you'll, lot of trouble because
you'll have
of
a
you.
Meltdown.
I probably will. I have now an entire comic book fan base, which already, which I said, you know what? I'm not going to fight with these guys.
You liar!
I'll probably
You've been
let it go.
With them for a year.
Yeah, but like little things. Like I wasn't going to make it a big thing. And now,
I didn't make it a big thing.
I know you.
I just
gave
a normal review for a comic book. A normal, intelligent review of normal notes, normal Hollywood notes.
Maybe I should have let you know that this was the obvious end result when you're reviewing the comic of a man who apparently, by his own metrics, has created the perfect comic book.
He called himself the Michael Jordan of comics.
Did he
said
really?
This would be, during Eric July's 3-hour cry fest of my totally normal, like, plot structure notes.
Yeah.
He said, this is like somebody telling Michael Jordan how to play basketball. And I said,
wow.
Are you fucking kidding me? Yeah, you're not even Scottie Pippen. You're not even Marty Pippen, dude. What are you talking about? Michael Jordan of comics?
As someone has brought
Michael Jordan
up,
also played basketball. He didn't just make money selling shoes. He actually played basketball, too, you jackass, Eric.
Why do I feel like this feud is going to go on for way longer than I thought it would originally?
I just gave some simple notes.
Well, apparently you've incited an entire fan base to hate us and hate this show. They've been clipping our show to report on all the horrible and mean things that we say.
And, Yahoo!
Yahoo! Well... And every day I gotta wake up to like 50 of these Eric July guys telling me I'm the worst fucking person that ever existed.
Yeah.
And that my comic's gonna fail and that I should kill myself. So that's been, thank you everyone for all your, I'm so glad Dick reviewing it. I didn't even review it. I had nothing to do with it. I didn't tell you to review it. I didn't even tell you to fucking read it.
Yeah.
You found it yourself.
Nina Infinity did.
Nina Infinity
Nina
really
Infinity
put you on the spot.
Insolently challenged me.
She thought you wouldn't do it.
She spoke to me very disrespectfully.
Mm.
And Eric July and Izom both know that I don't take no disrespect from no one. No woman.
Yeah.
I pity the fool.
You're a real Avery when it comes down to it.
I'm beavery, I'm savory, yeah. I'm every very in the book. I don't take no disrespect. No one no disrespect me.
I think you had some very reasonable, we share a lot of the same criticisms.
There's no plot in his book. There's no plot in his comic. There's no plot. There's no character development. He didn't make any fucking choices. And then in the book, the main character says, I'm not a good detective. I don't know why I'm doing this shit.
Yeah,
so
I'm not a detective. I shouldn't be doing this.
So I said, he wrote a detective book, but he didn't put any of like the plot, character development, character arcs, challenging the characters, like a a detective book is tightly crafted.
Oh, yeah.
Where there's clues and shit, and he didn't do any of that. And then he goes, where anybody say it a detective book? Like, well, the guy says...
The guy literally
that's
admits...
That's right, after he called me the N-word 3 times and told me to pull up on him.
All right. Well, that's just his way of speaking, I suppose. He called you the N-word with a hard R?
A speech impediment doesn't make it a different word.
Oh, okay. So you get the colloquial N-word.
Not to me, it's not. you guys may use your word your way. We use it a different way.
Yeah.
Okay? They don't... You don't, you don't get to use yours. You don't get to... anyway...
It's been a fun week. It's been a wild. I honestly thought that he would be like, okay, those guys made a stupid review. He might say like one thing like, yeah, fuck those crackheads or whatever. But literally for like 5 days straight, he's been going into our replies and guys who like follow us.
With everybody.
Yeah, guys who have like 10 followers. He's going, well, clearly you don't understand Avery's. I shouldn't use the voice.
I clearly. Don't know why you would do that.
He's going, clearly you don't understand this
like shit.
And this.
Christ.
No, it looks fantastic.
Wow, it looks like all flat and horrible.
And he gets really hung up on these. Yeah, again, when you go, I think it's
dude,
a
dude, you have $3 million. Fuck off.
Yeah.
Like, you don't have to write any of the rest. You just hire writers. Please.
Well, I guess a lot of his success has been based on the idea that, oh, he owns the libs and he owns the haters or whatever else. I'm like, yeah, but these are just a bunch of guys who think your comic sucks. Like, they're not.
Well, the libs are better writers than you, so.
Most the many
people
of
in
them.
Hollywood know how to take notes.
Yeah.
I mean, they may be pedophiles, but they may be satanic pedophiles.
They may be pedophiles, but they understand a three-act structure, okay? And that's what really matters. Let's do it!
I feel bad until I hear him talking about me, and then I'm like, fuck you!
Biggest problem in the universe.
Welcome to the biggest problem in the universe. The only show that ranks every problem in the universe from having no understanding of the price of an S to choosing any one of 1,000 ways to make your comic book suck less. I'm your host, Dick Masterson. Joining me as always is Vito Giswaldi.
Hi.
Long riddle. That was from Jazz Blister.
Thank you, Jazz Blister.
Long, long riddle. That's what I want.
Exciting, complicated rhymes that tickle the tongue. That's the kind of writing we like here
on
the show.
Oh, man, I don't even know. This doesn't even translate to a podcast, I think.
We could do a
this
whole show
today.
Just on the last week.
The biggest problem with
like,
last week.
Yeah, the biggest problem with Eric obsessively tweeting to every single person that follows us.
I have never seen someone take criticism this badly. Not even like that scene where Hitler's freaking out. shit, right?
I mean, the smart thing to do would have been to go, well, he has some criticisms, and maybe
yeah,
there's some fair ones in there.
He's more experience than me. I mean, obviously,
yeah.
Like, his notes are structured like he's gotten them a lot.
The honest thing to say is to go, well, I feel proud of it as my first try. People are excited about the character, and I'm looking forward to what we do next. I think it can only get better from here. But the only...
Because I'm the worst, meanest person on earth.
He's really...
Because I am.
Yeah.
I am mean, and my heart
sure.
is small.
Yeah.
You can't even
he
see it.
He should have rose above it, yeah.
Yes, that guy's fucking mean,
ooh,
and
mean
I tried
Mr.
my best.
Masterson is just needling this hardworking black man.
But... I know what I'm talking about.
Well, I hate to say it, but certain other comic professionals have come to me in private and went, I thought Dick's critique was fair. I don't think he was...
I gave you notes.
I mean, it is a comedy podcast. We're going to dunk on the guy a little bit because it's funny. But ultimately, the notes hold up. And you did give me notes.
I was restrained.
You were very restrained.
Oh, I do not like bad art.
Dude, you could have said a lot more. I think it was pretty fair what you put out there.
Thanks.
The Ice Hump fans do not agree. They think they have accused, and here's what is driving me nuts, is they're saying that you're jealous of Eric on my behalf. That you're mad that my comic book isn't making enough money.
But it's already a success.
And first of all, I'm very happy with the amount of money we've raised.
You're
it's pretty good.
You're not supposed to make $3 million
on
your first...
Yeah, it's not... Normal comics don't normally make millions of
like
dollars.
Like if you're like a super industry pro,
yeah.
Like, yeah, but if you're like you or yeah. like
it's a, my first
know.
Time out the gate. I got a little fun project and I'm like, hey, this is pretty good. And everyone's going, you're just jealous you didn't make $3 million. I'm like, making $3 million from a comic is kind of ridiculous. To the point where I kind of questioned the numbers and exactly who put them together. But that's a whole other story. All right. Yeah, but
Glenn
the
Beck?
Idea...
You think Glenn Beck shoveled somebody
idea,
in there?
I'm
gonna go get these limbs with your comic. We gotta get these limbs with your comic, Eric.
It's curious that other guys who seem as big as Eric...
Maybe Avery can get to the bottom of who really funded this comic.
It would be a fun
comic.
Detective
Maybe
story,
Maybe that's the detective story.
I'd like to know exactly where the numbers came from.
Once I get done with figuring out what Rumble's all about and what this money's for, I'll get to work on that one.
There's stuff going on. But like as I point out, Razorfist just did a comic. He didn't raise $1 million. And Razorfist's got a real big audience, I feel.
Yeah.
A very dedicated audience. Anyway, that's a whole other thing. But the idea that you would be jealous on my behalf and then feel the need to attack this guy to because you're mad
just
my
read
comic
the fucking
didn't
notes,
make money.
Though. Just read the notes and tell me that they're, like, they're very simple notes, like, about story structure.
Yeah.
Just...
I mean,
I put what I thought the summary of ISOM was into ChatGPT, and I said, write me a plot based on the hero's journey, and it fixed it.
Yeah.
Like, it just took what was there and just made it better.
It didn't have two fights against the same security guard for no reason. That doesn't advance the plot at all. It ends with the cops showing
there.
Up and chasing him away, where I'm like, well, what the fuck's the point of him fighting him? Just to fight him? It's to show that he's strong and he's back. I don't fucking know what the point of any of this is.
People seem to like it. I was worried that people wouldn't want to see my autistic review of a comic, but
no,
they did.
People have enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. I think it's insightful, and it's, you know, I was talking to you. I'm saying we should do some, like, movie reviews. I think people enjoy your insightful critique.
Here was today's.
Okay.
Junk Goat says, Eric, bro, you should rein in these people, this Rip a Cold Post, this other account. He's making you look weak and like someone who doesn't get jokes. We like jokes. Jokes are funny, unless maybe you are the Rip a Cold Post. And Eric says, nobody makes me look weak. If your view of me looking weak is based on another person that isn't me, you're a pussy. And he says, man, you really are a bad writer.
Yeah. You're pussy. You're pussy. You're pussy.
Dude.
He can't read is a weird thing as well.
Now
I'm being mean. Is that too much?
Something. I'm not in the fucking culture war, man.
Yeah.
I think this shit is fake. I don't think spending $35 is kind of... change.
I think it's all
politics.
A marketing campaign. It's all a
marketing
campaign.
Campaign, which I, for a year I have said I'm fine with.
Yeah, I guess
great.
if you want to sell fucking woke chocolate bar or anti-woke chocolate bars,
good
okay,
for you.
It's dumb as hell. But advertising is dumb as hell.
But I'm not going to say you're a good writer.
You're a great marketer. You figured out what marketing is currently working. Hopefully, it's going to stop. Did you see Trump told everybody to stop fucking saying woke about everything?
Trump knows.
Trump, I was like, that was the smartest thing I've ever heard that man say. I'm like, he knows.
Everybody wants to be respected.
Stop.
Everybody wants to be respected. Like, a woman, it's not enough that she's hot. Mm. It's like, well, what about my mind?
Yeah.
And like, well, yeah, your mind's fucking shit. What do you mean?
Your
what do you
mind
mean, what about
shit.
Your mind? Your mind and your personality are horrible. That's why God gave you those tits that
yeah.
you got, right? Mm. But no, that's not good enough for anybody. Actors all want to be fucking musicians. You think your music sucks, though, because you're not a musician. Oh, how dare you?
Timcast makes great music, Dick.
What's worse, Tim's music or Eric July's writing? What do you think? Let's get a poll. Let me get a one for Tim and a two for Eric's writing. All right. Is that...
Look, all these people
that
have
one hurts,
a very
right?
good grift going, and I don't know.
That's my superpower. They got to keep me chained up with my mouth closed.
Yeah, because otherwise you might say something and cause them to lose their fucking minds over
I'll be
it.
At the... Oh, what was the guy in... I keep wanting to say The Hunt for Hannibal Lecter, but that's The Hunt for Red October. What is the...
You're talking about Silence of the Lambs?
Silence of the Lambs, yeah.
The Hunt for Hannibal Lecter, as it's commonly known in international markets.
What was the warden of prison there, where he was?
I don't remember the
Boston,
guy's name.
You don't remember? He's like, why don't you tell me a story? And how... I'll give you some notes on it. And then the next scene is like... Okay.
It's been a while since I've seen Silence of the Lambs. Dick, who won last week?
Me. Losing shit.
Hmm.
Making decisions was after that.
Wow, I suck.
Yeah, mispricing nostalgia, that was down there. And then very special episodes was last. I don't know why. Those are horrible.
Everybody was like, no, I really like the episode. Somebody posted the... the N-word locker from Family Matters. Was that it?
Oh, yeah. Was Laura. That real?
Yeah, I think that was from an actual episode. Is that, wow, that Laura was... goes to close her locker and the N-word scrawled across it. And Urkel goes...
The E or...
I think it was an ER. Yeah.
Wow.
And I was like, wow, Urkel exists in a universe with systemic racism. Fantastic.
Yeah, Carl's fucking contributing to it. Okay. Tomton says, superhero that tell women, you better do what I say or I beat you. And go around killing random people for no reason because they told him to leave. Run away from cops after killing people. Did he really do the superhero? He says something else here. I don't know what that's. That's very
well. I understand the point he's making is that how is this guy ever a superhero? I saw him just as somebody wrote in a review. So one of our fans reviewed it, and Eric was very mad about the review. But he says
that review. Isom
shows up in the club, and the heroic employees of Club Merc
try to
stop this evil black man from ruining a good time. And I was like, that is kind of what's happening. Yeah.
Tony Gibrani says imposter syndrome just sounds like a way for rich and successful people to twist their accomplishments into a pity party. That's true.
Mm.
Good point.
It's not always maybe.
Yeah. I'm all so rich and successful, but I just don't feel like I deserve it. Can you make me feel like I deserve it too?
I feel fairly confident in some of my skills.
You?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some of my other skills, I feel impostery.
Kiwi says, can we get a strong wiener comic? Whether it's written and illustrated by a child or AI, it's going to be better than ISOM. Maybe.
I want to make more comics now. I'm excited.
Buddy, you got your one comic to make.
Yeah, I know. And that's my focus.
All right.
Once that's on the path, who knows?
Chief Wahoo says, how is this even against the culture war anyway? It's basically a crappier Black Panther. I don't know.
Well, that's also what drives me nuts is that it is everybody does go, oh, we're winning the culture war. And I'm like, but this isn't even like a culture war thing. It's just like a guy.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, but that's enough because like if the liberals made it, he'd be gay and fucking dudes. And I'm like, liberals make
How
stuff
do you know he's
about
not gay.
And there are liberals who are just
he
making
lives with
normal
a guy
stuff.
Out in the middle of the woods. It's pretty gay to me, or out in the middle of the ranch or
it's
something.
A little, there's something kind of homoerotic there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They didn't even say what his ranch does because it's doing man milk.
Well,
it's harvesting.
And he hires a bunch of white slaves to run it for him.
Longwell Coat says, I lost my speaker a month ago and I refuse to buy a new one because I fucking hear it somewhere. I can hear what's playing music off this phone right now. I know it's here somewhere.
How can you not locate the speaker if the speaker is making noise?
Maybe he's an idiot.
It must have fallen under the couch or something.
Jason Fuckua says, the reckoning coming. Vito's way when Super Killer comes out. Oh, I think this is supposed to be read. The reckoning coming Vito's way when Super Killer comes out. Dot, dot, dot.
Ooh.
He's been talking shit for years. Hopefully there won't be much ammo for people.
Okay, but the difference is that if somebody came to me and said, I didn't like this part of your comic, I would go, well, that's interesting. Maybe I can improve upon that. I wouldn't go, this crack smoking...
N-word. He called me the fucking N-word.
N-word.
Has
no
N-word.
Business. It's actually been weird because some of Eric's fans have been like, I don't like the art of your comic. And I go, well, I think it's technically proficient. Maybe
yeah, leave the artist out of it.
Like, well, I also don't think the art is bad in any way. I'm like, you can say you don't like the style, but...
Yeah. I'm sure the artists really love what I'm doing.
I don't know if he's aware of it. I don't ask him. I'm always worried that one day I'm going to get an email where he's like, hey, I finally listened to your podcast and I'm out. Luckily, he's Mexican. There's enough of a language barrier that I don't think he's going to listen to the podcast.
Jared S. says, I'd 100% buy the incredibly stupid woman comic.
You should do that. See, you said you're not going to make comics, but then everybody's telling you got a golden idea.
Maybe I'll do that.
It'd be pretty great, a woman crashing cars. And
I can't charge $35 for that shit.
You don't have
though.
To charge $35 for it.
$10.
Yeah, you can make it like a cheap, like floppy, whatever the hell thing.
Maybe I'll just do it for Christmas.
Or you could do it as part of the magazine that I pitched to you.
Yeah, Rev, while I decided to read ISOM to see if it was any good, the biggest takeaway when I finished was that if someone asked me what it was about, then it would be impossible for me to explain it to them. I now understand why the synopsis was so bad. Okay.
It's about a black guy who spends 100 pages going to one building, fighting a guy,
yeah.
Then going away, then going back to that building and fighting the same guy.
Yeah, okay.
With no development to any character or
for anything. No reason.
Yeah.
And Newman.
He found Jasmine, and she said...
She didn't say anything.
Yeah, she kind of just walked away.
He grabs her, and then in the very next panel, some security guards grab him, and then he says, is that any way... You got to grab somebody aggressively? Is that any way to treat somebody? And you go, well, there's you doing that to her right there.
Remember when he visits Darren at the beginning of the comic?
Yeah.
Could have found Jasmine then.
Yeah.
It could have been like... And then from there, the mystery could start unfolding. Yeah. Instead, after like 80 pages, it's like, oh, there's Jasmine. I'm like, well, what is the point? There's no... All right, whatever. We're going down a rabbit hole. Well, Dick, you're the winner. Oh, never mind. But we first have to do our favorite segment.
Right.
Vote it up!
Vote on the problem!
I think we did that one already. Yeah.
Shit!
We definitely did that one already.
Hey, Toe! P do V do.
All right.
P do V do. P do V do. P do. Holiday decorations. Fake news and inflation. Black people's reparations. Vote it up. Blaming you for voting. Fear self-promotion. Puppets that are broken.
Vote it up.
If you don't vote, I'll mutilate your family.
Yes, I will.
Biggest problem, not show. That's where you have got to go. Criminalizing straight sex. Bonus full of incest. Getting your band-aid wet. Vote it up. Fake mobile game ads. Bam, 60 your glass.
Keep it going.
Twice
as long. Twice as long, guys.
Good
Thank
solid.
You.
Good
Thank
solid
you.
Minute there.
Blitzkrieg Bop.
From Mao Zedong, it says. I was going to say.
Wait a minute, what? Oh, Blitzkrieg Bop, that's the name of the song?
Blitzkrieg Bop is the name of the song.
Okay.
You don't know
is
the,
his name voted up,
The
Stinger?
Ramones?
I don't know any song titles.
Well, the Blitzkrieg Bop.
I also can't hear lyrics ever.
Well, the Ramones were not known for their verbosity, their
Mao Zedong
enunciation.
Okay.
From Mao Zedong. Well, Dick.
Yeah.
Back in episode 27, digging back in the archives for a problem called smoking is too cool.
Right, I remember that.
Well, Canada has just announced that it will begin putting individual warning labels on cigarettes and other tobacco products in an effort to further reduce their appeal. They will be the world's first country to use this measure. That means each individual cigarette will now be printed with various anti-smoking messages, Dick.
Like I'm a Epsler.
Well, I have. They should say that.
This is a cock. Have just a little picture of Dylan Mulvaney on it going.
Oh my God. That would work. Why don't they just put like a bunch of trans and gay shit all over it? If every fucking cigarette was rainbow colored, it would stop so much smoking so much quicker.
Camel should have like a gay pack and they should go like, you know, actually we hate smoking. That's why we put fucking trans shit all over it. Cause then you're not going to buy it. Right, guys? Right? That would be awesome.
Well, Dick, some of these individual health warnings on each cigarette will include slogans such as cigarettes damage your organs, cigarettes cause cancer, poison in every puff, and worst of all...
That sounds cool!
That does sound cool.
Poison.
But here's the worst one. Cigarettes cause impotence. Can you imagine smoking that in front of your friends?
Yeah, but if you're talking about impotence, she's thinking about your dick.
That's true. Poison in every puff.
Are they
going to
go throw a hissy fit when I criticize these slogans? Not going to work, because people have a death wish, man.
No, I think...
Oh, how dare you say that about our ad slogans?
I think at the point where you got to put this is killing you on the cigarette, just admit you lost. Just give up. Who cares?
Yeah.
Everybody knows. Everybody doesn't care because, again, smoking is too cool. It offsets any amount of thing you do. And honestly, it does make it cooler to put poison in every puff on there. You go, yeah, I'm going to fucking die.
Well, because it also sounds like alliteration.
Yeah.
Like, your doctor doesn't... Your doctor doesn't say, like, I'm sorry you have large cell Hodgkin's lymphoma. He says that. Like, he doesn't say, like, oh, you've got, like, a...
You've got lucky lymphoma going on here. And you're like, ooh, a little alliteration. That makes it fun.
Got a spell in your cell.
Yeah. You could just... If you just put pictures of penises... If cigarettes had to have a picture of a penis on it so it looked like you were sucking on a little penis...
Yeah.
You'd be done.
Or if they just put a little semen in them.
If there was a little semen in every cigarette.
Yeah.
And they had to add it by law. You'd go, oh, yeah, that's the thing.
Not harmful.
Yeah, exactly. You're like,
you're required to have the filter and a little bit of pig semen.
Hold on, that's fucking genius. Because, like, tar, you're like, yeah, whatever. It's in my lungs. That's cool.
Fine. I don't care.
Dude, you're fucking smoking jizz. You
filter doesn't work because you put your fingers on it. Like, well, what about the
every
the
cigarette
pig
should
jizz
have to be a little slimy. Like, it's been dipped in jizz.
We have to do, by law, we have to make one cigarette in every
every
thousand,
like, carton
has to have a full of pig jizz all in it.
The whole thing. And when you smoke it, you know.
I don't think everyone around you knows. I think I just need one cigarette today.
Why are we not on the health council? We could fix this overnight.
Because it's all a big popularity contest. Like, you got to learn how to play ball and not tip the canoe.
Well, Dick, Smoking Is Too Cool is currently ranked number 309 with only 100 upvotes. I feel like we can get it up there, guys. Don't forget to vote it up. Other problem, which you'll remember, I believe you brought this one in, going all the way back to episode 22.
Yeah.
Going back to work.
Oh, man, yeah.
Well, you know who doesn't want to go back to work? Are these
teachers.
Amazon employees, Dick.
Oh, why?
Who walked off the job Wednesday, calling on the company to reconsider its return to office mandate, as well as curb their greenhouse gas emissions. I don't really understand how those
are
related.
Who cares about that
shit? I don't know. They just tried
to get
them
dumb
both in at the same time. Nearly 2,000
greenhouse gas emissions. What?
Bitch, we don't want to work. I don't give a shit about that at all. Nearly 2,000 Amazon employees joined the walkout. Starting in May, Amazon began requiring employees to work from the office at least 3 days a week.
Yeah.
What do you think? Should people be forced to go back to the office, or should we embrace this new work-from-home lifestyle?
I think we got to bring everyone back and fire all women.
Mm.
But you can't do one or the other.
You got to do both.
Yeah. You can't have everyone working at home and firing women.
How about
and
all
just
the
have women have a vacation? But if you're bringing it back to the office, I get it, because everybody's work. There's more like work getting done. But we gotta get rid of women. We can't. We can't make everyone come back and have to tolerate that shit all day.
Yeah. Now is the time. If we remove women from the workplace, men will naturally want to return.
Send them to Ukraine.
The women.
Yeah. Need some fresh bodies over there.
Well,
for the meat grinder.
I don't know if that's the exact solution. All I know, Dick, is that going back to work is currently number 52. That's pretty high. 563 upvotes. So don't forget to go to the website, biggestproblem.show, and vote it up.
Oh, shit, I moved it.
All right.
That was a really good
That was such a
that
good
That was a really
setup.
Good transition. Shit.
I perfectly nailed it.
Shit.
Blitzkrieg bop.
Yeah,
one.
I see it now.
You
v
fucked up my transition.
Do.
Oh, God damn it.
V. Do.
B.
Do.
Yeah,
Do.
I get
Do.
It. All
right. B. Do.
B. Do.
B. Do. A little decoration. Sickness and infection.
Stop laughing at this.
Sack people's reparations.
So
dicked up.
Asshole. You are the winner for this week, Dick.
P. Do.
Stop it. You don't even know what the song is. You don't even know what the song is.
So dicked up.
Oh, yeah, my...
If you
what is your problem?
My problem is people who pretend not to get jokes.
Oh, man, I can't imagine. Pretending not to get the joke.
Yeah. This one was today. Keith Olbermann.
Keith Olbermann.
You know that guy, that sportscasting guy that's pretending to be in politics now?
Is that what he's doing? I don't know what he's doing.
He used to be a sportscaster. And then
yeah, I know that. But, like, what does he do now? Does he even have a – he doesn't have a show.
He complains about Trump, I guess. I don't know.
Does he have his own show somewhere?
In this case, Chrissy Mayer, who's a very good friend of ours.
Yeah, we love Chrissy.
She's making this obvious joke, right?
It's pretty ridiculous to just assume that Chick-fil-A – I mean – you know, I'm hesitant to make a fried chicken joke, but they sell fried chicken. I don't know how much more inclusive we can get here.
Okay.
I really want a longer clip, because it kind of felt like the Newsmax guy was like, oh,
I
no.
Would like, I think if there is a record for how uncomfortable you can make a joke, I would like to see what it is after that.
Yeah, she really, if you're going to make the joke... I think you just got to you just got to stone face it.
What are people saying? They're not inclusive. They got fried chicken.
The thing is,
I just got to say that. I mean, I have dated black guy, but I mean, I didn't know. Like, it wasn't a thing I was doing. I have a great relationship with my dad. That's not to say that that would be a reason. Oh man! But my point is,
look, I will give. I will give Chrissy credit for even attempting that joke. I would not have attempted that joke.
We're going to get to you. We're going to get to what you would or would not attempt.
I've attempted some, I've said some things.
Here is somebody going, yikes. Oh, man, like, you know she's making a joke. You know, and I support hate speech and jokes equally. Like, they're both free speech, whatever. But
yeah, I don't want to cancel Chrissy over this. It's a pretty...
Yeah, but this is like a you guys know this is a joke. Keith Olbermann knows. Look at this. He says, "Look at this piece of shit," and he says, "POS." Chrissy Mayer being overtly and proudly racist.
It's also like the most boring form of racism. It's like, guys, come on. We've been making these jokes forever. Everybody knows you make a fried chicken joke. It doesn't really mean anything.
Here's another one that. Here's another one of two guys that are obviously making a joke that. Now, you thought that this would come back and bite you, right? This fan art.
Yeah. I really. I wonder why I was worried. I wonder why I was worried that this would come back. This fan art of my character kneeling on a black man's neck, which has now been retweeted by like
125,000 views.
Jesus Christ.
60,000 people saw this. This is us looking at Vito's super killer fan art.
As expertly edited by a moron to take out all the parts where I go, well, obviously I don't approve of this. So it's just a video of me laughing at a George Floyd joke involving Eric July's character, Isom.
I remember when you spent like 3 minutes disavowing it, and I was thinking in my head, they're just going to clip this out. What's the point of disavowing it? With that.
There's a number.
Isn't that what your guy does? He kills superheroes. Yeah, right? You remember that.
Yeah, it was a great bit,
that
honestly.
The guy did the fan art, of which is cool.
Yeah.
And he said you could make posters of it.
And now I have people saying, well, that's how they are, these racists. They're the real racists. And then, look, he's got us laughing. Dick, those screenshots of us laughing are not even from the same episode.
Oh, really?
That's from a complete... I didn't have that hat in that...
Oh, you're right. Look, I have my hair looks like shit in this one.
Yeah. So he took other pictures of us laughing to make it look like we're laughing way harder at that image.
He took a picture of me with a better hair.
And I'm all like color graded to be like red
like
for
the
some
devil.
Yeah, I look like the devil. So they really, again, we look way more racist when you take pictures of us laughing that fucking hard from a different episode.
I guess.
I mean, it is just a bizarre thing. I don't know why he couldn't have grabbed it from the episode he was mad about.
Here's another joke that people never take. We'll always pretend that they don't understand.
Well, yeah.
Vito. Hey, yo, Vito. Vito says, non-offending means that we understand breaking the existing laws is a no-no. This guy says, hey, yo, Vito, who's we? And you say, me and the rest of the child predators.
Yeah, I'll never get away from that joke. Chrissy Mayer, you know what? I do have to give Chrissy Mayer shit, though, because she pulled the I don't get the joke on me on a Nina Infinity stream.
That's right!
Where I had said...
That's right!
It's like, where did you get this or something? And I was like, they were like... God, I forget exactly what the joke was.
But you're right.
And I said, like...
That's when that beef started.
Yeah.
For me.
Yeah, and I was like, oh, my 14-year-old girlfriend gave it to me. They were like, you're a pedophile because of this. And I said, I'm not a pedophile. That was my 14-year-old girlfriend who did it. Or something stupid like that. And then Chrissy Mayer was like, well, I just don't see how that's a joke. I'm like, no, it's an expertly layered joke where I'm denying pedophilia accusations while talking.
Well, it's not serious.
No, obviously
not. So it's got to be a joke then if it's not fucking serious. That's the difference between the hate speech guys talking about FBI crime statistics and father and single mother baby. They're fucking serious. They're not making jokes.
I think we really need the people who go, you should be able to joke about anything. Like, okay, well, that includes all jokes, guys. You know, everybody defends Chris Mayer for...
But it happens. Now, the reason I say this is because it happens across the political spectrum.
Yeah.
Where we've just seen Keith Olbermann is liberal, you know, one of these liberal pussies.
I don't think Chrissy Mayer is racist because of that joke she made. I think she's racist because she hangs out with Anthony Cumia, but that's a whole other thing.
That's a joke. See?
Anthony Cumia is not joking.
Anthony Cumia is not joking. Look, if there's anyone I can say is just actually racist, Anthony Cumia.
Which I don't care.
Which is fine.
I'm not saying anything.
I can't stop you.
Not that there's anything wrong with that.
Well, it's not great. It's not great for a legendary broadcaster to be tweeting the N-word that many times, but sure. I can say that. Chrissy, she's got plausible deniability.
So she's getting the treatment that she gave you.
Yeah.
I don't see how that's a joke. Like, well, he's, a comedian.
She's a comedian. It's clearly a comedian in her bio. Making the oldest joke in the world about fried chicken entertaining the African-American population.
Jimmy Kimmel in blackface. You ever see them post like, oh, this liberal saying this? Here he is doing Carl Malone.
Yeah,
he's all in blackface. Like, well, you guys know that he's joking, right?
Right.
Like, what are you trying to do? Make him look black? Like, make him look racist?
There's a lot of weird tit for tat of like, well, you're actually, that's what they're doing to us. Is they're like, those guys make racist jokes all the time. And then we make a joke, which we didn't make. Somebody else made that art. We were reacting to it. And they go, well, I mean, whatever. Maybe we could have drawn it ourselves.
Racist jokes
fine.
All the time. I don't give a shit.
Yeah, half my problems are pro-black related for some fucking reason. And they go, oh, those guys are the real racists. And I go, no, we're all joking. Everyone is joking.
That's irrelevant.
Except
it's
Anthony Cumia. He's
That's
not joking.
That's not racism. It's a joke.
Right.
Racism is like turning you down for a bank loan.
Right.
It's not. It doesn't matter if the joke is racist. And you know that. You know that. You know that it's a joke. Roger Waters dressed up as a Nazi. Did you see him?
Yes.
That?
And everybody saying, and that wasn't, I don't know if you even called it a joke, but it's satire. It's satire. It's a joke.
Thing.
It's in the realm of,
Kramer at the Laugh Factory.
Okay. Well, that might be,
it's a joke. See, you can't even get on board. You as a comedian joking about me and the rest of the child predators can't get on board with the fork in your ass.
I mean, I got banned. One of my accounts got banned because of the Kramer joke.
What do you mean?
I had my second Twitter, which I'm actually trying to get back because it had like 10,000 followers.
Oh, yeah.
Stone Toss posted like some comic he has that shows Kramer on stage.
Right.
And I just responded to it with, what is the quote? 500 years?
50.
50.
50. 500 years, you'd be on a different continent.
All right.
We don't have to worry about it. You know what I mean?
50 years ago, we'd have you upside down with a fork up your ass. And somebody reported me for making a threat. So that was the ultimate.
Yeah.
Not, what do you call it? Knowing it's a joke.
Pretending
you know
it's
a joke.
Yeah.
And pretending it's a threat. Excuse me.
Trump doing the thing like, oh, I'm so confused.
Acting like a retarded
guy. And they're
guy.
Like, oh, he's doing a disabled, retarded joke. And he's like, well, no, that guy doesn't do this, though. He's just like, his hand's like kind of goofy. Like, he's not going, oh, and you know that what he's doing. You know he's going like a guy, like a woman driving. Like, like you do the same phase. It annoys me because the people doing it know. They know that they're doing it only to trick retarded people who legitimately don't know that it's not a joke.
Mm.
There's a lot of stupid people that don't understand jokes and don't know when something is a joke or not, don't understand metaphors, can't think of an apple. If you say apple, they're like, just, yeah, apple, the word. They don't have any picture in their fucking head.
The guys who think that we are racist towards Eric July because we don't like his comic.
And the guy posting about it knows. Keith Olbermann
knows. Yeah, they all know.
Chrissy Mayer knows that's a pedophile joke.
Yes.
Okay? Everybody knows, but they're lying about it to trick people who are retarded in that way into thinking that it's real. And they can't tell the difference.
Well, they also do that thing where they go, yeah, he's joking about it because that's what he really believes.
Yeah.
That's what she really thinks about black people. It's like, you don't know that. You gotta have evidence of that. You can't just say that.
I promise she doesn't think that Chick-fil-A has fried chicken because of black people.
I think she also knows it's not bringing the black community together.
Nick Fuentes saying 6 million cookies you need, like you can't bake them in the oven.
I understand that joke, and I can't.
Obviously
fault
a
the
joke
man for that joke,
right?
Yes.
Obviously a fucking joke.
Obviously
and
a joke.
Oh, but yeah, can you believe
he's denying
said,
the Holocaust? It? Can you believe it?
If he's going to deny the Holocaust, he's not going to do it like that.
Do you got to do one Nick Fuentes shout out on every show now? Is that
that's
the deal you penned
contract
with Cozy? And once every show, I'll make sure to defend the honor of the great Nick Fuentes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I get what you're saying, Dick.
Yeah.
It's not good.
I think that's all that I had.
All right. Well, that problem is called...
People who pretend people not to get jokes.
Pretend not to get jokes.
Joke deniers.
That's a
no,
great
that's
one.
Not good.
Eh, whatever. We'll figure it out. It'll be on the website. Biggestproblem.show. Dick, it's the month of June. Can you believe it?
Yeah.
And June is everyone's favorite month because it's also known as Pride Month.
Gay shit.
Woo! Gay stuff yeah! is here.
Gayed up my ass.
Now,
yeah. Gay cars. Woo! Gay condoms.
Are you going to get a gay icon? Are you going to make a rainbow icon?
I'm going to get a gay decal right on my asshole.
I made a gay Twitter icon. I put a rainbow flag on my thing.
Nah, I'm not going to do that.
Well, I'll tell you why I did it, Dick.
Oh, okay.
It's because for the longest time...
you're gay.
Well, for the longest time... heteroflexible. For the longest time, we considered Pride Month. You know, we knew it was stupid.
Yeah,
like, yeah, it's dumb.
Yeah.
Everybody accepts gay people. It's a settled thing. You got gay marriage.
I honestly thought that.
Yeah. It's not, you know, you guys are always playing the victim. It's not like everyone's out here calling you Satanists and pedophiles
yeah,
every day of every week. And then it came true. And my problem is...
not enough pride? Are you reversing your previous
you
problem?
Know what? It's not enough pride, I guess. We can call it that.
Uh-huh.
The problem is conservatives, I had it as conservatives justifying the necessity of Pride Month. That way, for the longest time, it's like, we get it. You're here. You're queer. It's fat. We're fine.
We're used to it.
Just get over it, whatever. And now the rhetoric actually matches up to all the bullshit they've been saying. Like, they want to kill us and they want to take our jobs away and whatever else. And we're like, no, you guys are fucking stupid. And now it's fucking happening. And I'm like, fuck. Damn it. Because I still think Pride Month is fucking stupid, and I still think the Pride flag with the triangle is fucking stupid.
Yeah.
And it's stupid. You got to put a gay character in every sitcom and every movie. But then I go, okay, but then there are a bunch of guys every day who are telling me if a teacher tells her students that she's in a lesbian relationship, she should be dragged out in the fucking city square and shot for child grooming.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, God, guys, come on. You're doing it. And that's the worst part is that it's making...
You guys are asking for it.
You're asking for it.
You're asking for it.
You're asking them to triple down at this point. You realize it's going to make things... a million times gayer, because now it's going to be like, I'm not even going to just tell my kids I'm a lesbian. I'm going to come to school as a drag fucking thing, and I'm going to have my tits flopping around and show them dildos all the fucking time.
I like that you're using lesbians in these examples, because it makes it
lesbians
more palatable for me. Yeah.
If it was a gay guy, you'd be like, okay, well, that's a little much.
Yeah, if it was like some super hot teacher, it's like, yeah, she told us all about her gay sex lives. Like, go on.
Go on.
What did she, brought, did she say she, about the...
My teacher brought her lesbian...
look like
wife to class and they kissed in front of all of us. Nice.
Really
nice.
Well, how long?
Did you give her a little pat on the ass on the way out?
Interesting.
Just the art.
Honey, did you hear about this? Come on, come in here.
Look, it's fine. As I always say, there are a lot of sane people who have very common sense arguments about what's going on. I agree with some of the stuff where it goes, yeah, that book probably shouldn't be in that specific school library.
What about Black Aragorn? You hated that, right?
I'm mixed on Black Aragorn.
Okay, never mind. I can't help you.
Well, I don't know. I don't like it. I think it's stupid.
He's gay. What about that?
Yeah, if he's gay, then that's good. Again, there's some stuff that, you know, conservatives say where I go, yes, I do think some stuff's gone too far. Mm-hmm. I do think there can be some drag shows that are like really, most drag shows are fine.
Awful.
Some
of most them, drag shows are fucking awful.
Saying,
it's just the,
it's
the
stupid cabaret bullshit.
Black guys yeah. in town karaokeing and not well.
I understand.
That's why they yeah. should be banned.
I understand if it's a setting where like a kid is stuffing dollar bills in someone's thong, I could go, all right, I understand why you're offended by it. I still don't want to outlaw it. Like, I still go, look, as long as they're not fucking, if they're naked and whatever else, I get it.
Vito, they're just calling gay people pedophiles now. I don't
well,
know. Like,
yeah, I mean, that's the thing is that the rhetoric is now just like, literally, if you're gay, you're a pedophile, or you're yeah. trying to convert kids to be gay or whatever. And I'm like, I really don't think that's why. I think at the end of the day, it's like, well, then why show it to kids? And it's like, because those kids are going to grow up, and they don't want them to grow up and be like,
because there's gay kids. Yeah, that's why.
Well, there are gay kids, and then there's also normal kids who are going to grow up and vote for shit, and they don't want them to grow up going, man, I fucking hate gays, and gays are the worst. They don't want them to be gay. They just want them to be like, yeah, I'm cool with gays. I don't care.
This is your guys' fault for needing teachers. You guys just had to have your free state babysitters. And now you don't. And now you don't like what they're saying. That's too fucking bad.
Yeah.
You shouldn't have done this shit in the first place. You want to have kids so bad, you should have made enough money so you didn't need a second fucking job. You should have not built this giant socialist monolith to raise and take care of your fucking kids. And now now it sucks for you. And now your kids are chopping their dicks off. Well, that's too fucking bad. Maybe you should have thought of that before you did something this fucking stupid.
We are kind of in a hole in terms of, like, it's not going to get better, guys. Like, it's just this is what you had. Yeah, you created public school.
You messed it up.
Who's going to become a public school teacher? A bunch of weird queer guys who got, you know, don't really care.
No.
And women.
No, women.
Yeah, well,
just women.
There's some guys.
You think if women stop talking about gay shit, they're going to come up with something better? I don't think so. The devil you know is better. You want to? If you make it illegal for women to stop talking about gay shit, you're not going to believe what they're going to start talking about. They're going to start telling your kids about money. Oh, yeah, it's good to have all your stuff on one credit card. It's good to have it all in one place. Woo! It's good to keep your. It's good to pay off the minimum because then the credit card company knows that you're reliable. Wow,
that would be good.
You know what drives me crazy about it?
What?
How everyone talking about it has no concept of how many questions kids ask.
Yeah,
like they're like, well, the teacher's like popping this question. Like, no, listen to me. First of
they
all,
they really seem convinced.
First of all,
yeah,
all the kids know that they're gay.
Yeah,
all of them. All the fucking kids know that the teacher's gay, and they know who the gay kid in the class is by, like, third grade.
Yeah.
By the time they're in, like, fourth, fifth grade, they 100% know, and they have an idea of what they're doing, and one of the kids in their class is catfishing an adult as another adult. That's the fucking world, and they all know about it, and the ones that do kind of know about it know it's bad, but they can't, they don't know, but they can't, they're not going to rat out their fucking friend.
Right.
They're all asking their teacher every fucking day, hey, so what's your husband? What's your wife? What's your husband? What's your wife? What's your husband? What's your wife? What's your husband? And what are they supposed to fucking, like, yeah. You guys know, you've seen them once in a while, I assume. You could be fucking the greatest detective in the world, ISOM, and you still can't keep that shit secret.
Well, they seem to think that, like, just the kids being aware that you're in any sort of relation, they're like, I just don't know why they need to talk about that. It's like, dude, you're with those kids for, like,
because their friend has two gay dads.
Year.
That's why. Because they're calling each other gay all the fucking time.
Yeah. It's they really live in a bizarre space where they think that at this point, I guess they just want robot teachers. Just get robot teachers then. That's what they want. Because then the robot teachers aren't, you know, fucking and sucking and talking about anything. They just go, here is math.
And all the kids
learn
will fuck
the
each
math.
Other. That's why you need an adult in there. You go, stop doing what you're doing. Because little kids do that. Little kids play with their dicks and genitals all the fucking time.
The point is that at no point in time did I ever feel the need to, give out, say, hey, I support the gay community. I was like, they know they're supported. They're fine. And now this Pride
Month.
They're
doing better than me. That's what I always thought.
Yeah. And now this Pride Month, I feel like I really have to go, hey, gay, trans, lesbian people out there, maybe in my audience, like,
yeah,
we're cool. I don't think you're pedophiles, and I don't think you're trying to molest kids, or I don't think you worship Satan.
Is that so they buy your comic?
Yes. No.
You know who else?
It's because I'm genuinely
super killer.
I'm genuinely, like, if I was a gay guy, let's put it this way. Everybody calls.
You sucking cocks
okay,
over there.
But
if
I was
gay
like an out and proud, like waving the flag or whatever else, and every day, well, maybe I will be now. Maybe that's going to be my thing.
You're going to come in with chaps and shit and leather, like, biker
shorts
in here?
I'm
going to
get fucking a leather, like, suspenders and fucking nipple clamps because I feel like I have to. Now it's, like, my community. Like, I got to support my community. And the community that I previously was like, well, yeah, I don't know. These guys are fucking crazy F-slurs.
I might start doing amyl nitrate.
Yeah.
In support of the gay community.
Sure. Why not? I just feel like, And you know how, like, I've always been talking about, like, a lot of, like, I have a lot of problems with some of the trans stuff and whatever else. At this point, I'm like,
it's crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy, but I'm also
you can't make fun of it.
Yeah, but now, yeah, and that drove me nuts for the longest time. But now I'm like, you know what? I feel like I'm in that position where, like, I almost, I'm like, yeah, I still think it's crazy, but now I just don't want to talk about it because all that happens is a bunch of guys show up and they go, yeah, they work for Satan. They're pedophiles.
Pedophiles.
It's the same thing that happened with Star Wars. Anytime I want to talk about a topic, a bunch of conservative right-wing nutjobs show up and they go, yeah, Kathleen Kennedy's trying to make all our kids gay by destroying Luke Skywalker and making females the dominant force in the guy. And I'm like, now I don't want to talk about it. You guys have ruined it.
I just want to hate women. I don't want to be in all this, like, gay shit that you're talking about.
So,
yeah, they're trying to promote women. Like, yeah, because women are fucking stupid, right? Like, no, because they're trying to make us gay. Like,
what?
And all this shit with Target, where they're going through the Target and determining what is and what isn't Satan. And, again, they're calling Target and threatening. They're like, we're going to bomb the fucking Target if you don't take the Pride shit down.
And they took it down. They're like, we got him.
Yeah, we got him. Yeah, that's no the thing they're celebrating. Yeah, you issued violent threats. Why are you happy about
Why
this?
Why aren't you doing that to the government?
Yeah. So now I have to go, well, I'm clearly not on the side of that. Like, that's horrifying. What the fuck is wrong with you guys? I think Pride Month is stupid, too. But I'm not telling them, if you don't take it down, I'm going to kill you and your family, you fucking idiots.
Did you see the Dodgers did that?
Yeah,
that
the sisters
cross-dressing nuns shit. And they're like, their whole deal is to promote safe sex with gay men so they don't get AIDS.
Is that what the sisters do? That's the organization.
Yeah,
yeah.
And they're like, this is a blasphemous. Like, I really don't think. I think preventing AIDS is probably
it's
better
worth
than
offending
like,
a couple Catholics.
Yeah, you could cross-dress as nuns if you're stopping AIDS.
Yeah.
I think that's okay.
Also, if there was like, and let's be clear.
How many AIDS have you stopped? Have you guys stopped?
If there was an organization of sexy nuns for like guys that was like a charity,
every
nobody
calendar,
would say like, oh, this is offending me as a Catholic, blah, blah, blah. Like nobody would give
a
shit.
It would be cringe.
Yeah.
It would be like boomer tier cringe shit.
They'd be into it. Point is the newfound necessity of Pride Month is what you guys actually manifested it into being necessary. I can't believe you guys did that. Like, I was perfectly fine with just every year going, yeah, it's Pride Month. How stupid.
How stupid.
Fuck, it's so fucking gay, blah, blah, blah. And now it's like, no, we actually do have to celebrate gay people because a bunch of psychopaths want to kill them. Great. Thanks.
Did you see that lady, that trans lady that lactated?
Yeah.
Did you see that?
And I saw a little bit of it.
Poisoning her. And I was like, wow, that's weird. Right?
Like, ugh. It's pretty.
I wouldn't drink that.
Pretty gross.
Right?
Yeah.
Ugh.
Were you trying to get her on the show?
Yeah, I wanted to buy some of her milk.
She can't be getting that much milk.
Even if I get a little bit, you know, like the like the pig semen, yeah. I just need a little bit. I was like, yeah, let me get some of that milk, right?
Yeah.
And then guy's like, oh, she's poisoning her kid. I was like, really?
Yeah.
You guys are that upset by, what about just like smoking? Is that not?
Yeah, a lot of moms are smoking like, around their kids.
Smoking? Is that, how bad is that then? Versus like this weird lactating
I would need to see the science on what male hormone infested breast milk contains.
You know, you don't know how to read science.
You're right. I know.
It's not as good as regular milk.
It's probably,
probably
not nutritious, but it probably doesn't kill the kid either.
Maybe a little bit. You know, a lot of women can't lactate. So they got to use formula anyway.
I feel like this is a whole other issue. I don't know how I feel about the lactating man.
Why?
Breastfeeding the kid. I don't know.
Why do you not support Pride?
Do you want a kid to suck your nipple really that bad?
Me? No.
No, but this lady.
She does, yeah.
Yeah. Well, honestly, though, you know what's interesting? One of the weird things about, you know, trans people, or one of the criticisms is always that they're not really interested in child rearing the same way a biological woman is. Like a biological woman, part of womanhood is wanting to have a fucking baby. Yeah. So in a way, this trans lady is actually more of a woman than most trans women.
Oh yeah. Whenever I think woman, I think of someone with a bunch of science to to prove their point, right? Clearly laid out argument backed up by facts and logic.
I don't know what science they
are. Yeah, here you go. Well, here's a list of scientific studies I have that prove my point. Oh, wow, what a womanly thing to do that you're doing. I can see why you identify as a woman.
Dick, it's very
I can't tell you how many times that my girlfriend or mom has done that.
It's Pride Month, Dick. We have to celebrate everyone.
I mean, are you serious with that?
What, that I support?
No, that lady. It was like, here's all the list of scientific facts.
I think it's weird, like, oh, and wow, I don't want to know anything about it. I haven't looked into it, and I don't want to think about it, okay?
Sometimes I go into my mom's book club, and they're all, like, talking about what scientific studies they all read this week that proves something or other.
It's a very weird, complicated situation. You know what? It's your...
Yeah, you're holding that, honey, you're holding that upside down. It goes like that with the big words on the top.
It's her kid.
Yeah.
What if a regular guy, though, wanted his baby to suck
hilarious
on his nipples?
Hilarious.
I think, wouldn't I don't know be? What I think about that.
Well, it happened in that movie, Junior.
Yeah, does a baby suckle on the man's nipples?
I think they addressed that.
I haven't seen
the
Junior
movie
in a million years.
You think it'd be weird if guys, like, suddenly, because guys are all doing, like, I'm super dad now, and I want to talk about how I'm, the guys are like, oh, I need to talk about how I see guys not filling in as the dad, and that means I'm filling in as a dad with their baby Bjorn. Do you think, like, the next step of that is going to be doing lactating?
I don't know, man. We live in a very strange time. I kind of hope
not.
Not
to me. What?
I don't know how you just roll with the punches. I'm always like, I don't know what's going on anymore. This is horrifying.
You got to just go, wow, look at that.
I just want everyone to shut up about Satan and pedophiles. That's it.
No, they're not.
And the wokeness. At least Trump is going to get him to stop saying everything is fucking woke.
Yeah, he'll do that.
Oh, he absolutely will.
What do you think about DeSantis? Do you think he's gay?
I don't know if he's gay. I could imagine he's had an encounter. I don't know. No, he's
with a cock.
How many? He strikes me as the kind of guy who's only ever been with one woman his entire life, though.
Because then the rest were guys.
Yeah, the rest. Exactly. All right, Dick, what do you got for me?
I was going to do mail. I was going to do snail in votes because at first I thought they changed the policy for election
disinformation.
And we could talk about it. And I was just going to do election.
They didn't change
stealing.
The policy?
Well, they said you can talk about election stealing, but you can't disparage mail in voting.
Mm.
So I was going to do snail in voting.
Okay. Well,
do you think that snailing?
Let's just not quiet.
But then I thought that would be too close.
You literally just got banned from YouTube every day.
But I had a lot of strikes on that.
Okay, we have a lot of strikes. I'm pretty sure.
I don't think so.
I think if somebody
snailing voting's different because it's not. It says not real. Because, like, imagine if you put your vote on a snail.
Yeah, that would be the
worst.
And
it would go toward the voting area.
Stop.
But it's all, right?
Yeah, it's
don't
so
you
slow.
Think it's slow.
I hate snail voting.
Snail and voting. That's bad.
Stop. Pick a different problem. But what?
Would you agree that it would be...
Yeah.
Do you think, would you want to, would you trust snail in voting?
No, Dick, I would not
would
trust,
not trust snail in voting. What are your top three reasons why?
The sluggishness.
There's never been a snail in voting.
Sure.
Mass snail in voting in America, right?
Right.
So it's let's not test it.
Overseeing all these snails could prove problematic.
Their snails are probably always underpaid.
Mm-hmm.
And it'd be problematic. What's another reason? You can't keep your eye on the snails at all times,
yep,
right?
No, that'd be a
okay, this is my real problem.
Okay, fair,
I am
going to
put
enough.
Snail in voting up
you
there,
you can put
though.
Snail in voting on there. Let everyone know.
Why would you? What's the deal, man? You're faster than a snail anyway. Just walk your vote in.
Oh, we're not going to have this channel for very much longer. That can be your problem. It can be your problem.
I just don't want to talk about it too much.
Yeah, I know. Me neither.
That's why I got messed up. I got a strike for doing the O.J. Simpson versus Kanye thing.
Really?
Oh, did you know? Did you hear about that one?
Not exactly.
That OJ, he changed his pronouns to they, them. The juice?
The juice.
Changed their pronouns to they, them.
Sure.
And that's why Kanye was so upset with the Jews, because they get away with murder.
Oh, he was upset with the Jews. Juice.
Yeah, and the
OJ,
Jews.
OJ, the Juice
the
Simpson.
Jews are like, we're the biggest victim.
Okay, I got it.
We're
I'm
the
there.
Biggest victim. We're always getting picked on.
I'm doing the bit. I got it.
I got a hate speech strike for that.
I'm sure you did.
It was a long bit.
yeah, you got to cut it. You really got to cut it.
Semaglutide and Ozempic. That's my...
Semaglutide.
It's ruined. It's ruined.
They
so
look
many
so
fat actors.
Different.
We're going to have a world where it's just strong men and saggy looking men.
Dude, Tim Heidecker looks
lollipops.
Like he has cancer in the newest season of I Think You Should Leave.
Yeah, and Sam Richardson just looks like a ham. on a mannequin, like some sort of a weird suit.
Yeah.
The Ozempic, that semaglutide, that is it Ozempic? Is that what it is?
Ozempic is one of the name brand versions. So
oh, okay.
Semaglutide is the scientific name.
Okay.
And the two most popular forms in pharmaceuticals are Ozempic and Wegovy.
Wegovy. Sam Richardson on I Think You Should Leave.
Mm-hmm.
Usually he's my number two funniest guy ever. Right,
he's lost the funny fat.
Man,
we're not
going to
have
like,
any funny fat guys left.
This is exactly the problem.
Value me while you got me, folks.
There's not going to be any fun. Not only is there not going to be funny guys.
Yeah.
There's not going to be any fat women to blame all of our problems on.
Yeah.
You're just going to have like lollipop heads.
Well, you can make fun of that.
It's freaky.
You gotta look at Mindy Kaling.
Okay, let's see.
Let's see. She's got a swimsuit line now.
Ugh.
No, but you're gonna see her and you're gonna go, well, that's not the most recent one.
Where's the most recent
one? Oh, there she looks like fucking Kim Kardashian.
Where? Which one of these? okay, look at the size of her here. I'm gonna blow that
yeah,
one
bring
up.
Bring that
later.
One up. Look up like Mindy Kaling weight loss.
Weight
or something.
Loss?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, look, it's literally the suggested.
You weight just, loss. This one?
Yeah, you can look at that one.
This one with the swimsuit?
Sure. There's a
all
bunch
right,
of before
let's
and
check
afters.
It out. Here's her. See this? Look at how fat she is. That makes me feel better about myself.
Right. She. Look at that big old yeah. chicken arm, man.
Rich, not funny, fat. Ugh.
That meat. There's some meat on that bone.
Glad I'm not fucking something like that at home, right? I'm.
You got something to be proud of.
Yeah, I got something to be proud of with my no. life, not this fucking thing. Is this her now?
I think so.
What the fuck?
There was a whole.
This is her now.
Yeah.
It looks like her. It looks like their faces get all
collapsed.
Stretched out.
Yeah.
Something's going on with this Ozempic stuff. Everyone's turning into those scientists from 13 Monkeys, 12 Monkeys, whatever it was. Look at this shit.
Yeah, well, they look like completely different people. It's crazy.
Chelsea Handler, I don't want her to have a reason to feel good about herself.
Elon Musk uses it. They're saying, what's the guy from Grand Tour? From
Jeremy Clarkson?
Yeah, Jeremy Clarkson's
no!
supposedly shrunken down. Everybody's tearing away at the fat.
I hate it.
The only fat people going to be left are poor people.
Yeah, then it's going to be, and I don't feel good making fun of fat poor people. I only want to make fun of fat people if I think it's their
yeah,
like
it's their fault because they have access to other things. Yeah.
Yeah, even if it turns out to not be the case, even if it's
right.
just like a gummy.
You want the illusion.
Thing. I need the illusion to yeah. blame them for something. And then you're doing it.
Yeah, but I'm doing it all wrong and probably mixed it incorrectly.
Megan McCain?
Wow.
I need that bitch to be fat. God, please make this Ozempic
cause
cancer.
Hasn't she gone through enough?
Of what?
Her father dying tragically while serving his country.
Should have died.
In that POW camp.
Yeah. You know my uncle was in that camp with him?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Did he say McCain was a whiner?
He called him worse than that. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. He fucking did not have anything.
Not
to
have
say.
A good time.
Do you want to do that weight loss contest that we talked about?
Yeah. Do I have to weigh in right now?
You have to weigh in today. Yeah.
Okay.
They put money. They're putting money in a smart contract. And then
I feel like there needs to be more rules or something.
Here's the rules. Okay. Here's Vito's weight loss contest. Okay. 6 months.
Okay.
All right? How much weight do you think you can lose in 6 months?
I mean, realistically, I don't know.
Well, what's let's 50 pounds
in 6 months?
It's 10 pounds a month, man.
It's a lot. Normally, like, weight loss is 2 pounds a week. So how many weeks is that?
In 6 months?
Yeah.
Like 25? Half a year, so 26.
So it'd be 50 pounds.
50 fucking pounds in fucking...
All right, let's say 50.
50 pounds, okay.
I'm not gonna lose 50 pounds.
How are you... You just said that's a normal amount of... So what's the amount
like
that you'll do
like
it?
Motivated and shit.
What's the amount that you'll do it for? People will pay you money to do it.
Let's do 1.5 pounds a week. What's that? 26.
30 pounds? How much do you weigh now?
No, 26 plus 13 would be 40.
40 pounds? 40 pounds?
Put 40.
How much do you weigh now?
I don't know.
Guess.
300.
Okay, so you're going to weigh
260.
260? That's pretty big.
Okay, 250.
250,
fine.
Okay. We'll measure you. We'll weigh you after. Okay. And then we'll do a minus. We'll figure it out.
Okay.
So people will put money in the smart contract, and then every month we'll weigh you. And if you haven't lost, if you aren't on the way to losing that, that's a strike. All right.
Okay.
So the dividing, you know, the divider of that.
Okay.
So if you have to lose 50 pounds, if you haven't lost 8 pounds by 1 month, that's a strike, right?
Right.
Then you get 3 strikes, you're out.
And I don't make any money.
You don't make any money at all, reverts to everybody's wallet.
Okay.
All right.
So there's no downside.
To you?
Well, the downside is like, don't get the
failure and.
Yeah, but my whole life is that.
Okay. If you don't want. You don't want money.
I do want money. How much money is in the? Is there money in the thing already?
People can put in the money. No, not. We haven't made it yet.
Okay.
We'll make it though.
Well, the more money that's in it, the more motivated I'll be, I suppose.
We'll see about that.
I mean, if there's 10 bucks in there, I'm just gonna eat cookies.
Okay. Well, that's my problem.
There's 20 bucks in there. Maybe I'll put one of those cookies back.
Semaglutide.
Mm-hmm. Should probably keep taking it then, huh?
Yeah, you should.
I'm taking it. It's going great. It's gonna go great. I got all sorts of, as long as I can cheat with medicine, who knows? I'm still not on the maximum dose. That'll kick it.
You're mixing it yourself still?
Yeah.
I don't think that's right.
I don't think it's right either.
I talked to a doctor, but I don't think that's right.
I paid like $300 for it. I'm not going to throw it out.
You should talk to Keffels first.
Well, I got a grand. This problem's very on brand.
Okay.
My problem, Dick, is tardy drink refills. You know, when you're in the restaurant and all you want is another soda. Because it's the most important. I don't want to eat if I don't have a beverage.
Look at this right here. See this empty beers that I have here?
Okay, but like we all know, this is the worst part of sitting in a restaurant is going, God, I hope that waitress comes back soon. So I can get more of whatever I'm drinking, maybe even water. I don't care what you're drinking, anything. Yeah. The point is your drink needs to be refilled.
Or you're on a date and you're just like, okay, I got to, or meeting somebody. Yeah. Like, well, I got to get a, if we could just get, you know, yeah. No, I'm not fucking freaking out. I just want to know where the drink is. I need it.
I need the drink. The drink is the most, the meal does not happen without the drink.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Dick, I have a solution though.
Okay.
The first self-serving soda fountain machine was introduced in 1950 in U.S. chain store Walgreens.
Okay.
We have the technology.
To do self-serving drinks.
Just put up a self-service beverage counter where at any point a customer, if they don't want to wait, can approach the machine and obtain their own drink.
They have that at McDonald's, though. Why don't you just go there?
I think McDonald's doesn't even have that anymore.
No, they don't?
You got to go up to the counter and be like, the one near here, you got to go up to the counter and be like, can you fill my drink back up for me?
Did people ruin that? Did we have something good and a certain demographic of people ruined it?
Certain demographic. Stop it. I don't know who ruined it, Dick. Some places still have it, but there are always abusers. Especially, I think, in L.A., a lot of, like, kids just... after school, roll up with their moldy drink cup from several years ago.
Yeah.
And get themselves all the beverage they want.
What about 7-Eleven? You could eat there. They have a drink refill thing.
That's what once we invented the self-serve beverage counter, there was no need for this. It's part of the waitress illusion. The illusion that the waitress is working hard.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, where it's like, oh, she must be working hard. She filled my drink every time. But when you think about it, You could have just done it.
You've done that. You've filled your own drink at home.
Your whole life you've been filling your own drink.
Dozens of times a day, and you've never complained about it.
And you didn't give yourself an extra dollar for doing it either.
I never thought about it like that. I have served my own self dinner at home a lot of times.
Yeah.
And I've never been like, oh, I can't believe I'm so fucking out of control over here.
I mean, this goes back to another problem. I forget what it was, but the waitresses always want to convince you they have the hardest job in the world.
Yeah.
And the only way to maintain that illusion is with these false setups.
Like, yeah.
These problems that could be solved instantly.
Invented problems.
Yes.
Tasks like busy work.
We are ruining the American dining experience just so that you might feel inclined to supplement their wages.
Yeah.
In a perfect world, I'd be filling my own glass. You know,
what if you just brought in like a barrel or something full of
soda? Why don't you bring a pitcher to my table? Then I can refill it whenever I want. No, because they need this little excuse to check
in. What about the carafe? The carafe
is great. I would love a carafe.
Yeah. Like an IHOP.
I can't recall the number of times that my meal has been ruined just sitting there. And I'll time it at a certain point.
Yeah.
I'm like, it's been 8 minutes. She hasn't come back.
Right.
I can't eat this steak because it's going to be dry.
Did this happen to you today?
It happened to me recently.
Recently? Okay.
Yeah. And I was like, well, I don't want to eat it because then I'm going to be.
Yeah.
And you're just sitting there. You're waiting and thinking about the better world we could all live in. And we don't live in that world because we live in a lie.
They need to get one of those. You know how they get stipends for retarded people working at stuff?
Yeah.
Like the government pays them?
So yeah, just have a retarded guy who just fills drinks.
All he does is drinks.
And you don't have to tip him. Coke. That would be great.
He doesn't understand tips. You got Coke in the right hand.
Yeah.
Diet Coke in the left hand. That's all he knows. Like,
if you want
like
Sprite.
Space chimp.
It's on you. Yeah.
Sprite. Go fuck yourself, pedophile. Go eat somewhere else. And he goes around, boom, boom, bam. Put up skates on him. Boom, bam, boom, bam. Right? Right? Hey, you guys. Boom, bam. Superman on him. Suspenders, right?
Honestly, all waiters and waitresses should just be retarded people. They're about as effective as it. As long as you tell them where to go. All right, there's one guy who goes, Mitchell, bring this plate to that table.
I don't know about,
okay,
I don't know
boss.
About you saying that. You got a drool problem. If you got a retarded waiter,
you put little plastic coverings on the plates to make sure no drool gets there.
No, my idea
you're
is
trusting this guy with pictures
all
of,
messed up.
Is he gonna have like the little the pistol guns so he can like you know he's got fucking
yes.
bags of syrup on his legs?
Yes. Yeah.
All right. Psh, 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 psh. The soda tard. The carbonated.
You're so tarded, buddy. He skates away. Whoa. Put him on a trek. Like
a carbonated cripple, as they call him.
And he just goes around sitting on a little boat.
Guys. And he'd be really good at it. Like you could hold your glass up and he would like.
So do we hate retarded people because we're making these jokes? Like, is that the.
No, we love retarded people and we want more of them in
you
our.
You can't say anything about black guys. The second you say anything about, like, oh, do you hate black guys?
We love retarded people.
I
we
apologize.
Want them to have more jobs.
Comparing black people to retarded people in that.
Tardy drink refills, Dick. That's my problem.
Oh, I didn't know you had tardy in there already.
Tardy drink right. refills. Maybe they're not tardy enough.
Uh-oh. Yeah, okay.
Maybe I want them to be retardy. Dick, what were your problems?
Semaglutide, Ozempic, people who pretend not to get jokes, and snail in voting.
Snail in. Stop it. And mine was the necessity of Pride Month, the surprise necessity of Pride Month, and tardy drink refills.
Okay.
Vote on all the problems at biggestproblem.show. And don't forget to go and sign up at patreon.com/biggestproblem and back.by/biggestproblem, where we will soon have our new bonus episode. Dick, are we locked in on our bonus episode topic?
Yeah, we could do that.
Biggest problem in Spider-Man. The new Spider-Man
movie
has just hit the theaters.
I need some time to think about that one, though.
Oh, I got plenty of Spider-Man problems.
Okay. Maybe.
Got plenty of Spider-Man
I believe
problems.
You. All right, wait. I have two clips.
Oh, okay.
This one's from Eric July.
Okay.
Saying that I think he's threatening me.
Oh, no.
This one's to pull up. He's saying to pull up. And then I have Eggy's response to your rap.
To my rap diss.
Yeah. Here's
someone says in the chat, you're spending a lot more time on this guy than he spent on you. Okay. This guy's been talking shit for weeks, did a whole stream on me, right? And what? I'm the one spending more time. Actually,
why is he so upset already?
We didn't do a whole stream on him. We did part of a stream on him.
Yeah, I didn't do a whole stream on him.
No, you didn't do a whole stream. Took 30 minutes of a stream.
I got my nails did.
I did my nails did.
I
did
got
a
my hair
whole
done.
Stream.
Why would I ever do a whole stream on anyone? Put a crop top on, or what is it? A halter top?
Halter top, yeah.
Put earrings on and go, mm-hmm.
I think you'd make a good hoe, Mr. Masterson. All right, what did he say? What is this?
All right, well, he's lying about me doing a hoe stream.
A hoe stream.
Because I've never done that.
Someone says in the chat, you're spending a lot more time on this guy than he spent on you. Okay, this guy's been talking shit for weeks, did a whole stream on me, right? And I'm the one spending more time. Actually was nipping at the ankles for fucking, and then you got a co-host that had been nipping at my ankles for entire year. And you got there to say, I'm spending more time. I don't do video. Like, I'm the response agency. That's the whole shit that I be talking about right there. That's a problem. What's his name? Unfortunately, I'm not on StreamYard, so I can't fucking, like, highlight it. But that's the whole shit I'm talking about, where it's like, people treat the responding agency like they're the problem. Like, you initiate a conflict.
You're spending
you
a lot of time
this
talking
noise,
about
and then,
it.
And God forbid, I'm like, all right, what's up? Then you like, well, you're being dramatic there, guy. Like, come on, man, stop being pussy. Have y'all ever been in a conversation in your life? Like, serious? Or is it just like...
Wow, this is a long...
Vito, have we ever been?
Have you ever been in a confrontation?
We're on global news, getting our asses kicked for making fun of trans people at not just to their face, but at the global gathering of trans people in the middle of Hollywood.
Yeah, that was a fun one.
I think have you guys ever even been in a confrontation? We went to the trans parade in the middle of the gayest town in the world.
We got people trying to kick our ass.
Told them to go fuck themselves. Well, and then we got our asses kicked.
Yeah.
How's that?
I just want to say, it's not that you're responding. You can respond. It's that, like, again, we streamed for 30 minutes, making fun of the comment. And not even making fun of, reviewing. Giving some notes.
Yeah.
So the extent of your response should probably be about 30, probably less. Maybe 15 minutes ago. These guys, if you want to call us crack smokers and potheads or whatever, fine.
And N-words and hoes.
Yeah, fine. But then at a certain point, the response is more than what the initial inciting incident was.
Well, similar to the comic, it feels like it never ends because it never addresses the point.
How does he have time to write comics? He streams like this for hours
it only takes
every
him about
day.
20 minutes
I
to write the comic.
I don't think he wrote it. I think he like handed some notes to another guy. Because I'm like, how does this guy get anything done?
Dame Pesos was going to read it.
Good. I hope
Marsh was going to read it too.
I know. He's I'm excited.
I have big news. This is not my girlfriend.
Right.
I got a fifth grade English teacher.
Is it the same one you used before? I remember you had contact.
No, this is a new person.
New person.
This is, I asked a fifth grade writing teacher who has spent probably 30 or 40 years telling kids how to write the hero's journey.
Yeah.
And grading their papers. I asked them, and they're a big comic fan.
Okay.
Because some people are saying I'm not a real comic fan, even though I've read like The Tick and Dread and Screw. Like
comics.
I love.
Everybody
you know.
Knows comics.
Anyway, I asked a grade school English teacher to grade Eric's comic.
Yeah.
And I just got the results in.
Wait, you already got the results?
I just got the email.
Okay.
I'll read you the first sentence and then I'm going to read the review on my show.
Okay.
The first sentence is ISOM number one, I don't even know where to start. This is a fifth grade English teacher who has been grading children's stories for 40 years.
See, and now, Eric, you can respond to that. You have something more to respond to.
Good luck.
Yeah. But
good fucking luck responding to that.
If he spent a week going out a 30-minute review, I can only imagine how many weeks of him spurging out.
Man.
Yeah, we're going to get it. Jesus.
I don't even know where to start.
I'm excited to hear this.
Would you ever like your book being critiqued by a
by a fifth grade English teacher. I would hope they wouldn't say, I don't know where to start. That's a really bad sign. And again, part of the problem is that if Eric was just like a humble, normal guy,
I wouldn't have asked a fifth grade English teacher to review it.
If he just said, hey, guys, I'm just trying my best, we'd go, oh, okay, that's fine. But literally thinks that it's the greatest comic ever made.
Michael Jordan of comics.
Some people have asked him, they've been like, okay, so you think Dick's critique is invalid because he's a hater and whatever else. Has anyone ever given you a critique you agreed with?
What, me?
No, just him in general.
Oh, yeah. No, the answer is no.
He's like, no, there has not been a single legitimate critique.
He's calling women, like, bald. Like, they're asking, like, really simple questions. He's like, you bald-headed bitch. I'm like, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I've had some other people be like, I didn't realize this guy was so mean. I've had guys who were, like, fans of his, and they're like, I didn't realize he was so mean. I'm like, yeah, I just blocked him because anytime anything happens, he goes, oh, that fat piece of shit Vito. And I'm like, well, if you're just going to call me fat every fucking time, I don't want to talk to you.
Okay.
So I just blocked him.
Bald-headed
bitch. I've never said anything about his appearance. You know?
She just asked, like, if he retired. She just said the story was about him retiring and coming out of retirement. And he's like, you bald-headed bitch. Like, wait a minute. That is what the story's about. What are you talking about?
It's a very complicated situation.
Fifth grade.
Well, I look forward to hearing it on the Dick Show.
10-year-olds, dude.
Available now on Rumble and Cozy.
You know, maybe I'll let my nephew write Strong Wiener.
It'd probably be pretty good.
All right, here.
Look, then you like, well, you hit the responding agency like they're the problem. Like, you initiate a conflict, yeah. You talk all this noise, and then, God forbid, I'm like, all right, what's up? Then you like, you're being dramatic there, guy. Like, come on, man. Stop being pussy. Have y'all ever been in a confrontation in your life? Like, serious.
Yeah.
Or is it just like ending shit on the internet? Have you ever been in any confrontation in your entire life?
Okay.
Or is it just you do bitch shit, you talk behind people's back, and then go start pissing yourself when they find out and address you? Like, come on, bro.
Pissing ourselves.
I'm the responding agency. That's what gets me about this. Like, dude. I don't like y'all. I don't know y'all like that. I don't know y'all to like not like y'all. Like, I don't like y'all like that because I don't know you.
Okay.
Y'all talk about me. I'm just a responding agent.
No, you're comic.
Like, I have no reason to acknowledge your crackhead ass existence if you just shut the fuck up.
Once again, Eric, I do cocaine.
Yeah, crack.
I wouldn't even know where to get crack.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't want crack.
I probably couldn't even smoke it. I don't know if I'd be able to bring it into my house. It's so expensive.
But let's also be real. If you raise $3.4 million for a comic and everyone's saying this is the greatest indie comic of all time and it's going to change the industry.
I haven't read it, but it's amazing.
Yeah, you have to accept that people are going to go, okay, well, I want to read it and see if what they're saying is correct. Like, that's going to happen. It doesn't make us like... Like, yeah, I'm a hater. Sure. I'm willing to say
you're a hater.
Yeah. Me and Eric have had a thing. He's like made videos on me and my friends.
The problem is that you were right. I mean, the real problem everything you said was right. And I was, for the whole time I was saying, like, you're just fucking jealous. Like, he's selling a marketing thing. But now this happened. And I'm like, he's a fucking asshole. Like, he's a fucking dick.
That's what the problem was. I was like, yes, I hate Eric. I think Eric's a fucking idiot. I think the things he says is stupid. And on top of that, I don't think he can write a comic. I don't think he knows how to write. I've poured through his campaign and all the preview material. And then I finally got my hands on it. I read it. And I said, okay, it's exactly what I thought it was. This guy doesn't know how to write.
Yeah.
But yeah, you're right. Everybody went, no, you just hate him. And it's
hate him.
I can hate him, and he can also be a bad writer. those things can happen. That's
You're just not as good at explaining why as I am.
And you don't even hate him. You
no.
just yeah, you just actually read
I
the
supported
comic.
His campaign.
Yeah,
and it's like, well, the comic sucks. I feel like the whole time I was reading it, and all week I've been hearing in my head that line from Happy Gilmore,
mm-hmm.
which at the beginning when his bitch girlfriend goes, oh, you want to be a hockey player? There's just one problem, Happy. You're not any good. I just keep hearing that. I'm like, yeah, there's just one problem. You're not any good.
And that's kind of Eric's writing skill. It's like,
yeah,
it's fun to have a dream, and it's great that all your friends support
it's
your dream.
You made money.
But at the end of the day, you got to figure something out.
Good. Yeah. All right, here we go.
But don't go initiating problems and then crying foul. Don't do that shit. That's pussy. That's like going like a hockey.
Wow.
That is fucking pussy.
Oh,
that's
so
pussy
mad.
As it gets. And by the way, And I'm going to say this again, as I said, every year that we do this.
Okay.
What do we do every year?
That I'm talking.
You talking about Juneteenth?
Yeah, is this a thing? Are we racist? Is that what I'm about to find out?
What do we do every year? All right.
About, by certain crack smokers on the internet, you think I couldn't appear anywhere publicly without someone trying to come and get shit addressed. We got Dallas Fan Expo next week, or 2 weeks, right? We got the meetup. I better be feeling some energy when I'm pulling up there, okay? I better be feeling some energy. If not, we all know that y'all fronting for an audience on the internet. Because the fact that people ain't pulling up, I don't understand that. I'm giving y'all where I'm at, not hiding behind a fucking microphone and a camera. What? Like, I'm giving you where I'm at. Let's hash it out. Let's talk about it. Let's be men. Let's do confrontation.
Wait, what? How do we do confrontation?
I don't know. He wants us to go to a Dallas comic convention and
Eric,
do you want me to tell you to your face that your comic sucks? I can do that. I don't know what benefit it provides to
Eric,
either of us.
Antifa had bigger black guys than you, man. And they have bike locks and shit, and they have no money to sue. Like, I don't know what. What are you talking about?
If you want to meet at a public place and have me tell you to your face that I think you wrote a shitty comic, I'm totally down. I don't think either of us benefits from that. Like, I think I can tell you that on the internet.
I don't want to go to some gay comic convention.
I want to go to the gay comic convention, so buy me a ticket.
That wouldn't be offensive to you.
Right. I would have
the
fun.
Gay stuff, yeah.
Yeah, I like comics. I tell you, Eric, all right. If there's going to be a public
event. Was that an invitation for you to go to his thing?
I guess.
You should do that. Your comic would go over 100,000. If you go there and make nice with him. Because you don't have to be mean anymore.
Yeah.
Because I'll be mean forever.
Okay.
So you could just go, like, make nice. I'll try to talk Dick out of reviewing I Saw Number 2.
I don't think I could make nice at this point.
Sure,
I don't think
you can.
That's,
you did such a great job with Chrissy.
All right. Shut up. Frank, her fucking husband seems friendly with me now. So that's
good. Yeah, he's cool.
Yeah, Frank's fine. We like Frank.
Is he inviting you to his Comic-Con?
He's saying that he's going to be there and that all these haters should show up and confront him publicly.
I would ask him to put it in writing, but I think that would only make it more confusing.
Yeah, I don't know what you want. But Eric, if you want to publicly say that I don't have the balls to tell you your comic sucks to your face, I accept that challenge.
Yeah, that's...
I would have no problem going, Eric, you have made a bad comic book and you do not know how to write.
Because of the writing.
I don't know why you would want that. I don't understand why I'm a pussy because I didn't tell you it to your face, I guess is what you're insinuating.
Yeah, I don't know.
I just think you've gotten that message from me already. The internet can transmit messages effectively.
I don't think you can hide in front of a camera. I've never heard that before.
Yeah, I'm not going to hide in front of a camera. I'm not a good hider to begin with.
All right, let's hear the rest of this.
We need to pull up, Dick.
This was only... How long is this? This is only 4 minutes.
4 minutes.
3 hour of five, three hour
cope streams. Yeah, 15 hours of cope streams about your 30-minute review.
Yeah, my notes must have been really bad if they provoked. They must have been way off target if I...
Oh, my God.
But ain't none of that energy. I'm going around. It's all love and daps.
Okay.
Dap. Everybody want to dap, but I'm cool.
Yeah,
I'm taking pictures
all
off. Everything good.
What's a daps?
Everyone's sucking up to you because you made $3.4 million, Eric. Like, that's it. All these comic guys. I've talked to some of these comic guys.
Dude, do you think he's ever even, like, heard of The Emperor's New Clothes?
Dude, there's some stuff.
No, seriously. Do you think he's ever heard of the concept, the story? Yeah.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
But that's wild. What's happening. He's the emperor.
Well, he's got Thomas Sowell in the background, who's one of the greatest writers, his generation.
I don't know. Here's one weird thing Eric said is that he doesn't watch any modern movies, television, or read any modern comics. And I go, but you critique them constantly.
All the time.
How do you don't even know what's going on? So, like, I know he's not watching. People are like, are you watching The Boys? Are you watching Invincible? Like, actually good?
Yeah, I watched those on TV.
Yeah, and he's like, no, I'm not watching any of this mainstream woke trash. And I'm like... Well, then you have
from like that didn't start mainstream.
No. Invincible's based on a comic from like over.
Boys wasn't fucking mainstream before, too. I don't even think Showtime is mainstream.
No. And I'm like, how are you going to write if you're not even aware of what modern audiences are consuming? You have to have your finger on the pulse of some of that. And that's a weird thing about ISOM is that the writing does kind of feel like weirdly like dated. Like it's not. There's nothing like
I know what
new
you're talking
or
about.
Creative.
I know what you're
on.
Talking about. Yeah, I did get that feeling too.
It's like a guy read comics in the 90s and then stopped, and then just went back to you know what was going on kind of in the 90s. I guess I don't even
okay,
know.
Okay, let's continue.
Yeah, let's get
this.
The end.
Boy, I open my Twitter. You got motherfuckers calling me all kinds of shit. Shit, I don't even know what it is. Sometimes I gotta Google what the fuck this shit is. Like, what the fuck is that? Just pull up. Let's talk. Pull up.
Okay.
Why would
I hiding behind these fucking podcasts and fucking doing videos and shit? Doing videos and all
that's
that shit, and then not having a nutsack to just
you
be like,
you have a YouTube channel.
Honest about who it is you are. You're a shit stirrer. That's fine. That's perfectly fine with me. You're a shit stirrer. But let's be honest. Let's not try to take the angle where you being a shit stirrer is somehow good faith acting. It's not. You can't be both. That's cool. You're inflammatory. I'm okay
me or
with
you?
That type. That type of guy.
I don't
that,
know.
Like, that's not me. But if you're gonna be purposefully inflammatory, talk noise. Don't then cry and say, "Well, I'm just being the honest. I'm just honest criticism." Like, no, it's not. It's shit stirring. And just be.
No, it's not. It's criticism. It's not honest criticism. It's criticism.
Well,
it's like basic.
I mean, you're not lying.
Structure.
You're saying what you believe, and I think it's pretty
on
backed
the paper.
Up. Yeah.
You know, now it's for everyone to interact with.
Eric, when you make a product that raises a shit ton of money, you raised more money than fucking Keanu Reeves' comic book, according to your numbers, which are
you made more money than the
verify.
Person who wrote Star Wars 7 or whatever it was.
Yeah, you
probably.
Made a very good point. Is that like the people who write these Hollywood scripts that you're constantly railing
yeah.
against?
They that's what you're criticizing when you make these yeah. reviews is the writing. The special yeah. effects don't mean shit.
Most writers are not getting paid $3 million for a Hollywood
no.
script.
No.
So you're in a position to be critiqued and criticized. Especially
and
when
you did a worse job than that.
There's an entire sector of the internet that has thrown themselves behind you as some sort of savior of comics. I saw a guy comment on one of your recent videos where it's like, Eric is going to single-handedly save Western comics. When people are saying shit like that, I think it's pretty reasonable for critics to go, okay, well, let's see.
Let's take a look at it.
What would cause a man to believe this?
Yeah.
Well,
I got a good look.
I got to take a look at this. It must really be wow. the greatest comic that was ever written. And I don't think it is. Dick doesn't think it is.
Yeah.
If you want us to pull up, what do you want to do? You want to have a public debate? It's not that interesting. I don't want to have a fucking forum about it. Like, you wrote a
is
shitty
this
comic.
Like the 90s drive by shit.
Yeah.
Like, pull up. Hey, how come Isom jumps off the wall and then rams the guy through the same wall?
Why does Isom and that guy jump at each other, but they don't actually punch each other and they just land? Yeah, we're not doing that. Be more specific about exactly what method you want us to pull up. Like, what do you want? I don't get it. Do you want me to come over to your house and we, like, hang out? What do you want?
Do you want me to read you my notes? Because I watched your thing. I
pull up to the studio. Do you
want to
come in and we can go over the notes together?
Oh, sure.
Come on in. Sure.
There we go.
Who it is that you are. So-and-so criticize your comment just so you know that.
Oh, say my name, you fucking pussy. Everybody knows who I am. You big leaguing fuck. It's not that hard to say. There's no FRs in it. I know you could do it. Come on, Eric. Say my fucking name. Come on, bro. It's not hard.
He's worried people will find your review. He doesn't want him to see it.
Okay.
Both defended terrible people and cuties as well. Okay. Doesn't surprise me that bad faith actors have weird takes. I still have not seen that movie.
You
going to Anime Matsuri again this year. Potentially.
You haven't seen that movie either.
Cuties?
That's
no.
Another place
I don't
want to
see it.
All right, that's it. Yeah. That's it.
We're a bunch of weirdos.
Wow. It doesn't surprise me.
They have a weird taste.
They defend cuties? That doesn't surprise me.
At least we can name media we've seen. I've never heard this guy talk about anything he's watching or reading. I don't think he is.
Yeah. Okay.
If you're gonna make I'm gonna make the argument that if you're making comic books for the modern audience,
yeah,
you need to watch that Invincible show on Amazon at the very least.
Okay. Here's Eggy. He saw your rap and he's responding to you.
Yes, my famous.
Should we save this for next time? I think we should save
it
for next time.
We can save
it for next time.
We're running long.
Yeah.
The famous Eggy response. Well, guys, what a great show. Don't forget to vote on biggestproblem.show. And all our haters, if you want to step up.
Pull up.
And tell us to our face.
And get your penis out.
Yeah. What?
If you want to show who's... If you want to show whose nuts are big, you could find us at Eric July's booth. Just say, check out my nuts, and we'll jump out of the... we're hiding. Wherever you see Eric July, we're hiding behind there. And say, check out D's nuts. Check it out. If you say the code word, hey, Eric, check out D's nuts, we'll come we'll out and give you and, money.
Okay. I look forward to seeing his booth. I wonder how much money he's going to spend on that. Mm-hmm. Why is he not going to San Diego Comic-Con? Isn't that coming up, or is that...
We'll pull up there.
Hey, we'll pull up.
Down
let's
by the
pull
LBC.
Up. Do a Comic Con in LA. Maybe we'll come out. I don't know.
Yeah, I'll come out.
Yeah, I'll come out.
Get Dude, a after picture. After I sign too, I'll review it.
Yeah.
With a megaphone.
You wanted to stand outside Comic Con with signs and say, ISOM kind of sucks. ISOM has a story structure that a fifth grade
Holy
teacher
shit.
Did
that
not enjoy.
Caller, on this last episode, just opened doors for me. Like, a lot of times in conversations at work and shit, I will, like, be like, this, that, and the third, and talking about the show. And then I got to explain, like, the show, Dick Masterson, and then they're like, well, who the fuck's that? And I go, well, I don't know, fucking 20 years ago, wherever the fuck it is, he tricked Dr. Phil into looking like an asshole and, you know, chauvinistic, like, misogynistic, like, comedian. It was great shit. I go, oh, fucking great. Love him. And I'm like, oh, okay, yeah, all right. And then I feel like I lose credibility. Yeah. I can say, it's a fucking guy I know.
Yeah, better.
This, that, and the third.
Don't say this, that, and the third. I don't know.
Fucking, like, what, judgmental fucking people.
Did you hear what he's saying? This, that, and the third? He said that at the beginning, too. What
did
is that?
He? Is that a phrase?
Well, he said it. Listen.
I mean, I get what he's...
Listen.
Holy shit. That one caller on this last episode just opened doors for me. Like... A lot of times in conversations at work and shit, I will, like, be like, this, that, and the third.
See?
This, that, and the third.
He said this, that, and the third twice.
That's interesting.
That's peculiar.
Maybe it's a regional dialect.
Have you ever heard someone say this, that, and the third?
I wouldn't be able to recall it if they did.
Huh.
Named Vinny. Anyways,
but he's saying that if you want shorthand,
you
can now describe conversations had by me and Dick as my friend did this, and it cuts through all the bullshit.
That's cool.
Why don't you say this podcaster I listen to?
No, because that's...
all right.
Weird.
You can call us your friends. Who cares?
Go vote up the homeless.
Yeah.
Man, people acting homeless is just such a huge problem. Like, even if they're not homeless, it's just someone acting homeless. Like, I'm at a restaurant with my girlfriend.
I love a big sign in the middle of a voice.
Mr. Drunk Psychopath decides that it's time to start shouting about how much money everything costs.
Okay.
And, you know, he's like a few tables away from us. And he's just shouting, and everyone's just kind of like,
homeless.
You know, doing the avoid eye contact thing because they don't want to trigger the rage of the insane drunk person.
Oh, he's drunk.
And then,
buddy, you had a rough day. Don't fucking worry about
Anytime
it.
Anytime you start a voicemail and it's a minute 46, just cut it.
Just cut it.
Guys, give us 30 seconds, minute.
You don't need to
maximum.
Sigh and set it up, okay?
Yeah.
Like you're doing your monologue at Juilliard. There I was.
Yeah.
Restaurant. Say the fucking problem right away and then go 2 weeks earlier.
This is not the biggest problem monologue corner.
It's not the moth.
From now on, honestly, if it's over a minute, just like, and
cut
it's
it.
Not, just cut it.
Cut it.
It's
okay.
Too long.
All right. Here we go. 30 seconds.
Dick,
perfect.
Baby, it's me, Ramsey Dangerfield. You might remember me from when I got a sex change. My doctor, Vinny Boom Butts, when he was cutting off my penis.
Yeah.
He said to me, you're going to feel a small prick, Ramsey. And I said, I've been feeling a small prick my whole life. I get no respect. No respect at all.
That's pretty good.
The other day, I got denied entry into the transgender bathroom. That's it. All right. Don't see my dick.
Come on. I was all excited for the punchline.
Why did you call if you didn't have a fucking
write the jokes
punchline of the fucking joke?
That was a good start. Well, at least you tried.
I got denied entry to the transgender bathroom. They said, you're too creepy even for us.
Way!
Right?
Yeah.
All right. One more. I'm a big retard. Let's see what that one says.
Hey, Dick. Hey, Vito. Biggest problem in the universe is me, because I just realized how many of my voicemails you guys actually play. I bought the bonus episodes and shit.
Oh.
Holy fuck. I'm either the biggest retard, or you guys like bouncing off my terrible, retarded content, fucking shit.
Could
I'm giving
be both.
You guys. Anyway, love the show. And I think it's really funny when I'm listening and I hear you guys just start shitting on my opinion. It's actually really fucking funny.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for coming by, man.
I hate all your stupid opinions.
If you've ever sent in a voicemail that wasn't played and you're not paying for the bonus episodes, you may be missing out on your brilliant appearance on Biggest Problem in the Universe.
Yep. If you're not paying for the bonus episodes, you're already celebrating Pride because you are gay.
Sure. Absolutely. And we will have our new Biggest Problem.
Celebrate Pride by not buying the bonus episode. Yeah. At patreon.com.
Are we
going to
record today or tomorrow?
I don't know.
Maybe tomorrow.
What do you think?
I'm kind of tired. I'm
kind of tired too.
Yeah.
All this Eric July threatening me.
I know. I've been losing sleep. We're trying to figure out exactly how I'm going to pull up.
Every black guy with a homeless beard, I'm like, oh, is that Eric July? Oh, is that Eric July over there? Sir, can you write a narrative real quickly? Yeah, like I got one across the street. Okay, never mind. You're not an Eric July. You're just a black homeless guy.
All right.
Whew, whew.
Here's the concept. We go down Skid Row, find a guy who looks like Eric July, and pay him $20 to give him us his best idea for a comic book. Pitch it to us on the spot and see how it sizes up. I feel like they might do pretty good down there.
Like, and what's his superpower? The power to eat food? Amazing.
He can afford things with money? Wow, that's cool.
Oh, God, okay.
All right, guys. Well, thanks so much for everybody coming by. Coop for five. Thank you all my ho-asses ends for not killing yourself over Eric July's weirdo fans and his boring, poorly written, and poorly drawn comic book.
It's well drawn. I hate the artist.
I
has nothing to fucking do with it.
I think the art's okay. It's
great. It has nothing to do with it.
It's good.
Okay.
It's above average. Let's put it for an indie comic book.
I have no idea.
For an indie comic book,
idea.
The art is very good.
I'm not looking at the art at all.
Yes. And I'm kind of the same way. I think the art is good. He hired a good artist and a great colorist, Gabe El Taib, another guy who hates me. Gun Ranger for a big $20. Wow. These comic guys use indie like it's a synonym for anti-woke. They never bring up Boom or Valiant because they really just want to work on big budget Marvel DC IP. Their own comics are just as stale and generic, only a money grab. Yeah, they all just want to make their own Wolverine or Batman or Conan or something.
Well, but they want to work for one of the big labels. That's why they don't mention the smaller labels.
Yeah.
Right? Like, they're not like, we're going to help a small label. They're just like, fuck Marvel, me. Like, invest in me. Like, why don't you help the other little guys who've been trying to challenge the big guys for a long time?
Indie comics have always existed. They think it's like a new thing.
Yeah.
Or they think like that the indie guys who do exist, it's like, well, they're just part of the problem. We're the real ones. We got a comic about a black guy who walks around town getting beat up. It's like, man.
And aggressing people.
Yeah, and being confronting security
guards. And not understanding
guards.
Why people are upset with him. And running away from the cops.
And getting thrown through the air into a lady for no reason. Hot bod kebab for 7,000 yen.
Like $70.
What am I saying? How do you say thank you in Japan?
Arigato.
Is it arigato? I think it's arigato.
Is it? I'm a queer.
Domo
mom,
arigato. Yeah. Thank you.
Uh huh.
For some reason, I thought that was an apology, but they have a million apologies in Japan. Thank you for the Japanese
I don't know
money.
How to apologize in any language?
Okay.
Not even English. No language.
Well, you better learn, because we're going to have to apologize to Mr. July when we meet him at the Dallas Comic Con for some reason.
Well, I'm not going to pull up in Dallas.
I don't know if he meant
First
us
of all, that's
specifically.
Like, that's like Mordor for you.
Yeah.
Like, there's way too many black guys for me to go hassling you, super black man in Dallas, all right?
Yeah.
If we're going to be hassling anywhere, it's going to be in, like, Wisconsin or something. Actually, it's going to be in Juarez. That's where me and my lokes are going to sit around fucking tattooing old English on each other.
Maybe our fans can roll up on him and ask him what his current thoughts are on our delightful podcast. Goldilocks for a big $9.99. I have genuinely gotten the same feeling of listening to the show as I did when I first discovered another one with a certain Armenian. I can't wait every week for it. I will be buying Vito's comic after this. Guys, go to Indiegogo. Super killer. Right now at $42,000.
Really?
As Eric July's people have said, that means it is worse than iSum because it raised less money. And that is how quality works. Sadly, it will not be of the quality of iSum.
Man, they're obsessed with money.
They're
just obsessed with it.
Here's a weird thing you'll notice about Eric July. He's constantly talking about his warehouse, where all the comics are stored,
yeah,
and like packing orders and shipping orders and whatever else. And I'm like, oh, these guys just have like a weird fetish for like commercialism and commerce.
Oh, that's interesting.
Just like a guy selling stuff is more important to them than art.
Yeah, because you don't want to outsource your fulfillment.
He doesn't. He set up a whole warehouse and he paid a bunch of people.
Your time is worth more than that. That's like,
well, it should be, but I don't know how he has any time to do anything, but... they're really obsessed with his warehouse and how, you know, packing things and shit. Chilean Chile for $5.
It's like a deadliest catch, but the shittiest comic.
Honestly, if they made a shipping comics thing, I think all these kids would watch it as a reality show.
Yeah.
Chilean Chile for $5. Oh boy, another wild week for the boys. Vito should make a diss track against iSum or Eric July.
Oh, wait. I had this thing. Hold on.
Oh, God, what?
Let me get... Because he keeps calling me Buster Baxter. Right?
Oh, Buster.
Is this funny?
Why is he calling you Buster?
I don't know.
Well,
he said I have a big head.
That's true. Does Buster have a large head? Buster.
Yeah, you tell me.
Why?
You tell me. Look at his head, Vito. Yeah. This is a $5 million head, Vito.
Buster, were you critiquing this nice black man's comic book?
I was pulling up.
You were pulling up.
I was pulling up. I could do
his. Oh my God!
I could do his wife 600 times. I'm a rabbit, bitch.
Let me look for rap beats. Rap beats. Okay. Free rap beats. Hold on.
Just click that first one right there.
Is that royalty free though?
I don't know.
Here,
it doesn't
matter.
Wait.
No, it's not a rap beat.
It will be.
Can you rap to that?
I have to rap to it?
No, I wrote rap lyrics. Okay, I got ChatGPT to write me rap lyrics. Hold on. Yeah. Like that. Yeah. Right? Yeah. Yeah. Yo, listen up. I got a story to tell about a dude named Buster Baxter. Ringing the bell. He's a comic book critic, straight up with no filler, reviewing bad comics, making authors shiver. Buster steps in with his eyes on the page, unleashing his rhymes with a lyrical rage. He dives deep into the panels, no holds barred, analyzing the flaws, catch him off guard. Buster Baxter, king of the critiques, reviewing bad comics, bringing the heat. He triggers the author with his words so slick, unleashing the truth, making him feel sick. Yeah. He flips through the pages, ready to dissect. The story's a mess, the author's a wreck. Buster's got the power to shake up the scene. He's a comic book guru, keep it clean. With his wit so sharp, he exposes the flaws. No mercy for the artists who break the laws. It ain't about hate, it's about making him grow. Constructive criticisms, helping him to show. Yeah. Is that funny? Should I read more of this thing?
I don't know if you're on beat.
I don't know how to do it. I need like a deeper beat. I need one that doesn't have a Nike. Hold on. Rap beat.
I think you need to find the beat.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait. This one has money burning.
It's the same guy. Listen to it.
Oh, yeah. I'm the Buster Baxter. The king of... It's too slow. You're better at this
Here,
you do it.
Yo, listen up, I got a story to tell about a dude named Buster Baxter ringing the bell. He's a comic book critic, straight up with no filter, reviewing bad comics, making authors shiver. Buster steps in with his eyes on the page, unleashing his rhymes like a lyrical rage. He dives deep in the panels, no holds barred, analyzing the flaws, catching them off guard.
Wait.
Buster Baxter, the king of critiques.
reviewing bad comics, bringing the heat. He triggers the authors with his words so slick, unleashing the truth, making them feel sick. He flips through the pages, ready to dissect the stories of myths. The author to wreck. Buster's got the power to shake up the scene. He's a comic book guru, keeping it clean. With a sharp wit, he exposes the flaws. No mercy for the artist who's breaking the laws, but it ain't about hating, it's about making him grow. Constructive criticism is helping him to show. Buster Baxter, the king of critiques. Making them feel sick, the others feel threatened. Their ego's inflamed, but Buster ain't backing out. He's not playing games. He's calling out mediocrity and lifting the bar, pushing the boundaries, raising the bar. They might get triggered, but it's part of the grind. Buster's got speak up, he ain't leaving behind. His passion for comics is burning his soul, giving bad books a shake, making them rock and roll. Buster backs up the gang of critiques, reviewing bad comics, breaking the heat. He triggers the others, making them slick, unleashing the truth, making them feel sick.
Dick literally broke a sweat rhyming. Your sweat is pouring. Wow. All
right.
Hitting them hard.
Man, you're good at that.
ChatGPT is good at that, I gotta say.
Oh, yeah, I said, ChatGPT, write a rap about from Buster Baxter, from
you
Arthur.
You don't even have to write rap anymore. This is just literally good. This is like Buster Baxter, the king of critiques, reviewing bad comics, bringing the heat.
Yeah, it's funny.
Triggering authors with words so slick, unleashing the truth, making them feel sick. That's hot.
All right.
Fuck, rap's fucked. We're all fucked. It's all AI now.
Yeah, but you had to make it like sound good. I didn't know how it was supposed to sound.
Well, you just gotta find the rhythm. You gotta go. Yeah, but now they can even AI generate the fucking voice.
I just never rapped before.
You're gonna learn.
No.
We're gonna make you a seasoned rapsman.
Then I'll be smoking crack in no time. I'm going back.
We're all gonna be crack smokers.
Africa, you know.
I want to know if
the song Africa, not the country Africa.
Yeah. You're gonna go to Norfrica.
It's the rains down. Yeah, that I can do.
Lemon Trashy for two. If you're so smart, why ain't you pull up? Good point.
Good question.
Hot Bod Kebab for $2 says, I wanted a call to prayer, but I forgot the message. Well, he did donate.
You messed up. You got to do it again.
Yeah, you got to do it again. Doesn't count if you forget the message. You're grandfathered into the next one. Vito's hats are always fire. What's your shirt? I don't even know. This is from Into the AM. Use promo code VitoYT to save 10% off your Into the AM order.
What? Into the AM?
Into the AM is a t-shirt apparel retailer. Josh Denny loves their shirts.
Is it for Husky Gentlemen?
No, it's for everybody. Into the AM.com? Yeah, they're the ones I tried to get to sponsor our show, and they said $25 an episode. And I was like,
so now we did it for free. Fucking great. Could have got $25.
I get $300 every time. When I do a video. I didn't get anything for that. Brits Man for two. Thanks for not Q-tipping yourself. You're welcome. Petty for 10 has a flying bird man.
Cool,
fantastic.
Thanks.
Lol No for 5. Vito, I've been playing Flesh and Blood a lot the last few weeks with my buddy Slant. Your Slant buddy. Jesus. Phil Ayas Shos. Is he an Asian
with
gentleman?
My buddy Slant buddy?
I think he meant,
buddy
I don't know.
Slash buddy?
Buddy slash buddy. You guys should try it. I've seen Flesh and Blood, and I'm sure it's fun. I mean, I just don't have time for another card game. Pop quiz for $9.99 puts a yellow duck.
Like
with
a demon.
Yeah, looks satanic. Solid BM for 10 says, Drunk Goat here. I was surprised Eric talked to me. He should not have even cared about my opinion, but decided to call me a pussy. Lol, I think Vito will win this comics war. Well, it's funny that I was like, people are like, you're just trying to sell your comic by fighting with Eric July. And I'm like, well, not at first, but he's kind of making it too easy now. That all these like fans are going, your comic looks like shit, fuck you. And I'm like, well, now I want to prove you wrong. It's kind of becoming a thing. I know he'll say, oh, I'm not starting a war. And it's like, yeah, but all your fucking stupid fans are,
I've read the draft. I don't want to, like, poison people or one way or the other. I read your draft. It's better than his product.
Yeah. You had some critiques that we're going to hammer out.
That's all I do. I have critiques. That's what I do. They're not
notes.
All right, but that's what they are.
Yeah, Dick's notes were very solid. JJ for 5. Reminder that 75% of people who like ISM haven't read a single page. I saw a guy respond to him saying, I can't wait for your next campaign because I don't want to open any of the 3 copies I bought from you that are signed.
Good, done.
And I'm like, so you're buying the next comic and you didn't even read the first? All right, man. Why don't you crack one of them open and just read just it and make NFTs, sure you like it?
Yeah, just make NFTs.
Just make NFTs. At least then the scam is clean and efficient and it's over. Oh, God. Anyway, LP Dirty T for $4.99. Thank you for building the brick house. You now live in Eric's head rent free. Also, thanks for not killing yourselves. Thank you. Danny Fist for $5. Your hair looks nice, Dick. You should give some to Vito. I could use it.
Thanks.
Derek Juneteenth for $5. Your criticism of Isom is wrong because you look like a cartoon rabbit from a cartoon where the aardvark does not look like an aardvark.
Yeah.
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 Buster.
Yeah. Buster.
Buster Rhymes.
Buster Mad. Over your, I'll pull up your nuts, bitch. Wait, he's like that. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I gotta be real.
Yo, where's Jasmine? She's on my fucking jock, bitch. Yeah. I'm knocking her up, bitch. Yeah.
It's a clever reference. I just really can't connect you to Buster Baxter, of all things.
He's the guy that says, he's the guy that says, who would do that? Go on the internet and tell lies. I think that's why.
Did Buster do that in an episode of Arthur?
Yeah. He was the one lying.
Oh.
I think he's on that meme.
Right.
He's on that meme. Who would do that? Go on the internet. Would someone do that? Go on the internet and tell lies?
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
But Buster wasn't the one telling lies. He was the one criticizing the act of telling lies.
I don't know. I don't watch Arthur.
Well, I'm thinking if he should.
I watch Babar.
I was a Caillou. No, I didn't watch Caillou. Goldilocks for $4.99. Tim's music is just bad punk, but at least close to listenable. Eric couldn't even make one page that was coherent besides maybe the title.
That's true. But Tim's music is torture.
It's all torture.
Isom is funny. It's Isom is so bad it's funny. Tim Pool's music is not funny.
Wouldn't it be like interesting if the parallel economy had like something really good and you're like, wow, maybe this will work.
Yeah, like a new bank.
Yeah.
Not just a bunch of shitheads that can't
YouTuber
do stuff.
YouTuber vanity projects. That's all they have. It's bizarre. Yeah. Mega Man for $5. Eric is
Dan Boingo has a podcast on Rumble, though. Peter Thiel's scam
parallel
to make $500 million
parallel.
And do a Ron DeSantis fucking super PAC by paying off a bunch of influencers to not shit on him.
It's the parallel economy, Dick. What are you going to do? Mega Man for $5. Eric's so unbothered by your criticism that he's been replying TBF to random people all week on Twitter. The N-word. Thank you, Mega Man. Autonomous Prime for $5. Had a chat with Eric where I pointed out you asked Nina the same question if she read the book. Kind of stopped being pissy at me after that.
She read it. She said it sucked. Well, not, I mean,
she
not
said it in the nicest way that it sucks.
Yeah, if a woman ever reviewed anything I did like that, I would
jump off a bridge.
Off. Well, you know, here's my review.
Wow, I really appreciate all the effort
stop
you put
right
in.
There.
All right. Where do we start, Dick? Solid BM for $5. I hope Superkiller is better than Isom. I don't care if it's bad, but I hope it's not worse. I bought both A and B covers.
I can already tell you it's not worse.
I think it's better.
Gonna
be
it's
better.
In the draft I read
it. By my standards, I like it better. It has what I think is a pretty concise little arc. It doesn't tell you like, and maybe next episode you'll find out who he is. It's like, no, it's like, you're going to get it. And Jay Glover for $4.06, for $10. Vito, I know you got a lot of heat for crying. Never happened. But don't feel bad. I cried rewatching Cowboy Bebop. Of course,
what
I did it alone in my room where thousands of people can see me. I teared up at some Cowboy Bebop. That show, probably the last episode is like pretty intense.
When his wife gets shot?
No, that's the second to last episode. I think. Maybe it is the last episode.
When's the last episode?
Last episode is where he goes back to where it all began, and it's just like
making stir fry. That one,
where Faye, when he has that conversation with Faye in the hallway, and she's like, "Don't go."
And she's like, ugh. Like anime.
That was some good storytelling. Don't shit on the final episode of Cowboy Bebop. You motherfucker.
It's so weird watching a art from a culture where the women don't like talk constantly.
Yeah. It's interesting.
Yeah, it's amazing.
It's fantastic. And then they made an American version where the woman just won't shut the
fuck up.
Autonomous Prime for $5. Eric wants to monetize his haters, but instead of doing that with Dick, he keeps him nameless and keeps pissing his pants ranting. Yeah, I don't think he's making a lot of money off this monetizing us.
I don't know why he wouldn't say my name.
He's really deathly afraid of promoting anyone inadvertently. Like, that's us getting one over on him if he mentions our name or our podcast.
Yeah, but Eric July's fans are fucking retarded.
Yeah.
Like, they all have weird levels of autism.
Dude,
they're
all really, their profile like pictures
fucked.
Are them holding the comic.
Those people
I'm like,
are
is that all you
fucked.
Care about?
Please, don't mention me. I mean, I don't want to mention, but dude, they're fucking weird.
If you come into my Twitter mentions and your avatar is literally you holding the iSum comic to your chest like a baby, it's like, okay, we don't need to have a conversation. I already know that you have formed a disturbing parasocial bond with this guy, who we did discover has a $99 a month Super Mac club. Where you can get access to exclusive Eric July wallpapers and AMA sessions and whatever the fuck else.
He's not even like Musk. Like, if you're gonna Mac, you gotta be more muscular than that. I think.
Well, he's,
I bet I could lift more than Eric July. Maybe. I bet I could bench more than him.
I think that's possible.
How tall is he?
I don't know. I mean, he's the Michael Jackson of comics. Does he have the same height?
Ask Eric how much he can bench. I bet I could bench more than him.
That's interesting. Someone ask him that in his next chat, and don't tell him it comes from us, because he'll call us haters and crack smokers. How much do you bench, Eric? You're so powerful. Phrase it exactly like that.
Yeah.
John Refs for 5 says, I'm glad you guys like my iSum review. I did like it.
Yeah, it was great.
I'm now maiming iSum number 1 with GIMP into a decent story, having a lot of fun. I think I have brain damage.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
Both of your reviews were hilarious. I'll post them again.
I think you could salvage that book by cutting out like 90% of it. And changing, all the dialogue. Derek Juneteenth for 5 Australian. A critique of media is not valid unless you consumed it, unless it's cuties for some reason. Also, reading iSum doesn't mean your critique is valid.
Good point. Cuties is
as we've pointed out to everybody, they're going, well, Dick said it sucked before he read it. And I go, have you been on Eric July's channel? All he does is take Marvel comics and movies and TV shows that he admits he has not watched, read, or consumed, and goes, look at this leftist bullshit, fucking woke garbage we got here.
That's a good impression.
I want to roll up on the thing about when these haters come at you, and they come at me, saying, I got to roll up on you. That is a pretty good Eric July. A little note for 5. So vote it up with all your might and sleep well knowing you did what's right. For if you don't, I'll kill your family tonight. Wicked Tron for Canadian $11. Vito, thanks for not killing yourself. Screw Eric July and his super fragile ego. Guess he's now realizing not everyone will gobble his rod. I'm also buying your comic. Let's go. I think he, I don't know how self-aware he is. I think he really thinks that, like, everyone's on his side.
He thinks he's a good writer.
Yeah.
And
he thinks it's easy.
Well, maybe he just thinks he's, like, God's gift to writing. Like, he's a natural writer.
I think all these guys have also convinced themselves that the only thing wrong with entertainment is that it's woke.
Yeah.
So as long as there's nothing woke in the story, it's automatically good. And it's like, no, there's way more to it than that.
Story.
Yeah.
I was on Def Noodles podcast.
Oh, okay.
And he brought this fight up.
Yeah.
And I was like explaining like, well, yeah, you know, I mean, you know, Hollywood. No, it's like, you know what it's like to get a script noted, like the format that it's in and exactly what it goes through and like the character motivations and the questions for it. And then I was wondering when I was saying it. Do they think Star Wars is bad because it's bad as a story or because it like has a woman in it or a black guy? Like, why do they think Star Wars is bad? I know why it's bad, because the story sucks.
Well, that's
because it's missing like motivation, character arc, challenges, like it's missing all the same stuff I said is missing from iSum.
That's been my entire thing is that they go, yeah, you hate all that feminist bullshit in Star Wars too, right? And I go, no, I hate that the story sucks. Like, that's the problem. They go, yeah, but if we just took all the women out of it, I'm like, no, that's...
I would like that, but that's not going to make it good.
No. Yeah, and that's what it's become, is that there's, like, a certain group of people. There's this one guy who critiqued the new the James Bond movie where he dies or whatever at the end. Spoilers,
horrible.
Okay.
Horrible movie.
But his critique
I'll tell you what. I mean, yeah, go ahead.
You'll
go
tell
ahead.
Like how the story
Story's
doesn't
bad.
Work or whatever else.
Why you can't put James Bond with a child. Because then all of a sudden the bad guys are no longer doing their worst. Like they're like nerfing everything and James Bond is like now afraid. And you don't want James Bond to be afraid.
Right.
He can't jump off a building like with his fingers crossed with his fucking daughter sitting there.
See?
It's not James Bond
anymore. That's a good critique. there's this guy named, God, what's his name? Doomcock. And his review literally reads like a KKK rally speech where he goes, this is Hollywood trying to cuckold white men, taking white heroes and having them emasculated and destroyed. And I'm like, no, that's not what it is, man.
That's not why.
That's not the problem. Hollywood just hates white men. And I'm like, well, some of them do, and that is a problem, but that's not the specific problem here. Anyway, the saucy slurp. For five, when will you get Cardiff Electric on this dick show? Do we need more potato?
Tell him to call into my show this Sunday.
We'll have Cardiff on. Janie Cat for 11 Canadian. Hello, Strong Bad and Strong Sad. I want to decide if I should vote up or down for boycott of the week. Can we get a refresher on Budstock? Budstock is down. They've maintained the boycott. Maybe.
I mean, who knows? It's
all, it could also just come back up.
Well, you know what drives me nuts about the Bud Light thing?
What?
Is all of their numbers come from... this one liquor marketing company. No, all of their like sales figures come from one company. It's like they're down 80%, like from Butfo Middlestocks, like marketing. Let me look it up. Hold on. They always quote it. I mean, does anyone care anymore though? Like it's always, it's not Bud Light saying, holy shit, we didn't sell as beer. It's one marketing company saying our analytics tells us this.
I'm
like, yeah, of course it does.
I'm willing to say that maybe the conservatives finally achieved a successful boycott.
Well, Kid Rock did.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, we'll see. The thing is, you can't celebrate after 2 days.
Yeah.
Now you can kind of, honestly, if you want to go out now and say we did it, I'm totally okay with it. All right?
What did you win then?
Yeah, what do you get out of it is the other question. There's no more trans people on the beer.
You're drinking Coors now?
Well, I'm sure you saw that Modelo is now the number two beer, which is also owned by Anheuser-Busch. So
yeah,
it doesn't
outside
matter.
Of America it is, but
no.
Inside of it, but who fucking cares?
I also wonder if people are really gonna keep this up or if after a while they're gonna go, you know, I just kinda like Bud Light and it's over, so who cares? We'll see. Anthony Alicia for five. Chrissy doesn't need to be canceled for being racist. She needs to be canceled for being a horrible comedian. Oh, that's, how could you say
horrible.
That about the great Chrissy Mayer? Sorry, but she is really bad. No, we love her. P90X plus DVD. I don't know what my relationship with Chrissy Mayer is anymore. I think it's a respectful disrespect, you know?
No, you're just, you have an issue with people.
I don't like her Satan stuff. She's one of these people talking about Satan. Stop it.
Yeah, but it's a woman.
Doesn't excuse it. Any one of these broads who goes out and is actually worried about the existence of the Dark Lord Satan.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I can be friendly.
Is
I can
she really
go
on about Satan?
Yes, she said it in the studio. I asked, "Do you genuinely believe?" And she's like, "Yeah, I'm Catholic, and I genuinely believe."
Catholics don't believe in Satan.
Well, they shouldn't. They should. Okay, but I can be friendly. She's a comedian. I support
Italian, though, isn't she?
Yeah, some Italians take the Catholicism seriously. Some parts of my
Satan.
Some parts of my family take that whole religious shit seriously.
Maybe I was wrong. I don't know.
So when I see that, I have to go, okay, you drive me nuts. That shit drives me nuts.
Yeah,
but I don't, you know, I don't wish harm on her. She can have a fuck. She has fun with everybody else, so that's great. She goes on.
Just don't talk about Satan.
Yeah,
or don't do anything Satan-y.
Well, everything that's Satan-y to them is like being gay or celebrating it for any reason. So, P90X plus DVD rip handy subs for five. People pretending not to get things in general is the biggest problem. I know Vito will eject, but it wouldn't hurt to stream on that other platform. It's hard to set up multiple streams. Maybe we could. You want to multi-stream the show?
Yeah, it's not hard. I could do that.
All right, if people really want it. From 2B, nice try.
Yeah.
He literally made his... name the phrase. $5. What do you guys think of major sports leagues changing their Twitter picks for Pride Month, then changing them back one day later due to backlash? I gotta look into that. I don't know.
It's funny.
It is funny if that's actually what's happening.
MLB did that, I think.
They might actually tank Pride Month. Like, it's actually, they're kind of getting what they want. Is like, we want to destroy the gays and make it unprofitable to associate
with
them.
Well, I mean, I don't know if the gays really benefited from, like, MLB having a rainbow flag. Like,
yeah,
it's all,
I don't know.
It has all always been marketing for white women. And now it's like, uh-oh.
Well, maybe it just is that unpopular. But it is exposing the hypocrisy of Pride Month, where all these corporations are like, we love gay people. Oh, you guys don't like gay people anymore? We never liked gay people. We fucking hate them, too. And it's like, all right, well, at least now we've seen through the facade.
I just don't care. Like, I don't care what they should just change their logo to white and blue, you know?
For what?
I don't know. Just cool colors.
They should make it yellow and blue.
What's for what?
For our boys in Ukraine, fighting every day.
Oh, yeah.
My flag that got ripped down. Behoa gods for two. Somebody saw the upside down.
Just make it green for money. Yeah, all right, donuts. That's better.
$2. Who took criticism better, Eric July or Maddox?
They're identical. They're really identical. I wrote a full, like, an issue of Black Maddox, the man who was never wrong, as a comic. Yeah. I don't know if I'll, like, work on it more or make the art for it, but I did write it.
Some comic panels for you.
Yeah, I'll try. Maybe I'll get a Fiverr to do it.
Lemon Trashy for $5 European. If the audience is interested in watching Eric July's meltdown, search for Clip Sama. I spent so much time editing out him angrily squinting at the chat.
I'll play more on my show.
Fantastic. Lemon. David March for $5.50 Canadian. Good David March. My poker buddy. Vito, have you heard of Chris Gore's Critics Court? He's trying Disney for killing Star Wars. Surprised you're not one of the plaintiffs. I have seen screenshots of that. I have not watched it. Michael Winning for $4.99 USD. What happened to people on the internet? Everyone's so serious now. Simple jokes break people. Dick with Eric July. Chrissy, trolling is an art. I agree. Mint Salad for $20 says, I drew some Pride Month fan art for iSum and posted on my Twitter.
Really?
That's going to piss them off. Wait, no. She says, hold on. Read the next part. It's not safe to show on YouTube.
Well, okay.
It's very prideful.
What's Mint's Twitter?
It was Tits Mint Salad. I don't know if she had to. No, now it's Autistic Boobs. Sorry. I think she got banned. Yeah, okay. Show iSom. Everyone should draw some iSom Pride Month fan art.
Here, everybody go to my Twitter. It's there. Twitter.com/DickMasterson. That's some pride. Wow.
Oh, no. Why do I get the feeling I'm going to get in trouble for this?
Oh shit! I gotta do like a. Let me quote. What should I say to that?
Happy Pride Month. Happy Pride Month, iSom.
Happy Pride Month.
Let's just say that Eric July's character iSom has assumed the heroic pose of being on his knees.
Happy Pride Month. Always be on your knees for the Lord or something like that.
Happy Pride Month, Eric July. Happy Pride Month is enough. You got it. You nailed it. iSom is on his knees satisfying a certain portly bearded gentleman with a bunch of Q-tips scattered around on the ground to really...
You look at how angry he looks.
Yeah, iSom's not happy about what's happening.
So what, I'm the jerk because I tweeted that?
I guess so.
I'm just trying to boost a young artist.
You should step up, man. You gotta step up and go to Dallas. What a nightmare.
I hope I don't lose any friends. Or money making opportunities.
The fucking popularity contest that the internet has become. You gotta support everybody. Well, not if they suck.
I don't lose access to anyone's audience.
If that sucks, you like, shouldn't we value people who can like just say something sucks when it sucks?
No,
they all just want everyone to suck everybody off. And thankfully, we now have art to represent that scenario. Claptrap the Destroyer for $5. I suck other men should be the new June mascot. I agree. Chief Slinging Beef for $5. Vito, are you cool with school choice and using the allotted tax dollars to use for schools the parents choose, i.e., a tax voucher for high school or private school? You mean like the amount of money they would have spent on your child giving it to you to educate your child otherwise?
Yeah.
Well, wouldn't parents just take that money and buy a car? Like, I don't think they're going
to. Okay, so you don't want to give them the money. You have to
give them a voucher specifically.
For a school. You're fine with that?
I think private schools are fine. Yeah, I can't stop you. It's America. I mean, educate your kid however you want.
You can stop them. You just.
Educate.
He's asking you what you're allowing. Do you want to give people a voucher? Is that, and they can go to another school and use it? Is that okay?
and you give them the money?
I'd have to think about it.
You have to think about that? They have to go to a charter school. Here's your voucher, and you have to go to a registered entity that has registered with the
government.
Registered
with the state, and the state has made sure that the education standards are up to code.
Up to public school standards.
Sure,
yeah.
Fine.
Yeah. Right.
As long as there's some amount of, like, oversight, and they're not going to, like, Scientology Mystery College.
Well,
whatever the
why
fuck.
Is that? Why is that bad?
Sure, send them to Scientology Mystery College. I don't care. JJ for two. I think snails can't be trusted. All right, none of those snail in voting. We're not talking about that. No one's super chat about snail voting.
I can't even say that.
I know you can't. And we're not.
It's fucking dumb to have snails carrying around votes.
I understand.
It's fucking stupid.
I understand.
There's so many better ways to do voting than fucking snails.
Yeah, all right.
Okay. Who do snails even want to win?
I got it. It's understood. The concept, I'm there with you, okay?
I'm just
moving on. Goldilocks for $9.99. I vividly remember, shut up. I know you want to say more. Just shut up. I vividly remember Dick explaining the OJ bit to Vito before, after he got the strike for it. Are we sure Dick was the one who got assaulted? It's been a while.
Yeah. Shut up.
Antagonist for five. Ozempic has been shown to not just cut down on fat, but you also lose twice as much in lean muscle mass. You better start working out, bud. Thanks for not killing yourself. Absolutely.
Just
real.
Get on some steroids.
Yeah. Well, I would love to get those as well. The real Hydro PX for five. When will you guys make a locals and post some wife pics like Nick Riccata? Ouch. David Gomez for two.
When we get married.
Yeah, when we have a lady to show off. David Gomez for two. If I lose 30 pounds, I lose 60 in muscle. Fake news. That sounds, yeah, I don't know about that stat. Spider Eternal for five. Why do Vito's notes have a giant meat tube and sphere satchel? Did I just fucking?
Oh, yeah, look. You're holding up your notes and you drew a guy's cock.
I drew a cock.
Look. Oh, wait, you can't show that on YouTube.
Well.
Fuck. No, that got me fucking banned.
All right.
Showing
there's nothing
a fat
there.
Guy.
I drew a picture. By the way, it's my birthday this week. I turned 40. Thanks for not killing yourselves. You're welcome. Happy 40th.
Why
does
your notes have a guy's balls and cock, though?
I don't know. I just drew a dick. You never draw dicks? It's funny.
Well, not like a not on a guy, like his whole body.
It's shooting like a little cum cloud. We just looked at a picture of Isom sucking me off. That's fine. Why can't I draw this?
A girl drew that, though. A hot girl drew that.
All right. Well, sometimes I draw penises because it's fun.
Yeah, but you drew the thighs and stuff, too.
Well, I mean, it's...
And the ball. You drew the balls in a weird way. They're like... Should have.
I don't know how to draw testicles, okay?
Okay, look. That should be like
well,
that.
Well, now you're drawing it.
Yeah, but I'm just doing it to show you what you did
notes?
Wrong.
You're going
to
give me
yeah,
notes?
Yeah, look. See, that's how there's a thing in the middle. Yeah, I'm drawing boobs,
right there.
And I'm just not drawing nipples
on
them.
There's two balls.
Yeah, but you drew that one ball all the way up to his cock. That makes no sense.
It's a fold of the skin.
All right.
Spider Eternal for five. Already asked that question. Happy 40th birthday. Rusty Shackleford for five. Jamie Foxx got crippled by the magic liquid. Why did you vote for this veto? That's unconfirmed. We don't know what happened.
Who cares?
Yeah, who cares?
Who fucking cares about any of this COVID shit anymore?
It's exhausting at this point. Mr. Cool Ice. I love Mr. Cool Ice. For 20 big dollars. Thank you. I'm absolutely loving the drama. Keep it up, guys. Thumbs up, Mr.
It's
Cool Ice.
It's not drama on my end. I'm doing nothing. All I'm doing is sterilely critiquing a work of art, and Eric July's totally melting down and totally behaving in ways that are crazy and manic and out of control. I'm being totally normal and not doing any drama. There's nothing coming from me. It's all from him.
I want to stop talking about it, but literally, I'm just getting like hundreds of notifications.
I didn't even want to start talking about it.
That Rip a Goal Posts fucking page is talking about us every day and posting videos from our show.
And that's just an Eric July alt account. Eric July is just posting as Rip a Goal Posts. I don't even want to be involved in any of this drama.
He goes, well, that's not an official account. I go, all your employees are literally on there responding to it and retweeting it constantly. It's clearly either someone you know
it's
or someone
you
definitely
obviously
approve of.
You.
Well, it's something. Matt M for five. I hope Maddox teams up with Eric July on this fight. I wouldn't put it past him.
Yeah, sure.
Claptrap to Destroyer for five. Eric's eyes look so watery in this stream. Looks like me. Peter Hansman for $5.50 Canadian. Vito, please use the power of crying to convince Richard to do monthly Richardtations.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we got to make it happen. On the John for 11 big Canadian dollars. My crowning achievement this week was triggering Eric July with, why are you spending so much time on these guys? Comment. He was so mad he couldn't bring up my profile to bully me.
Yeah.
He couldn't find your profile. That's all he does is he digs into the profile. Look at this guy. Look at this crack smoker. All right, we got it. David Gomez for two. Eric July going for the Safeway Select brand, Mr. T. All right. P90X Plus DVD for five. Always imagined July would look like a distinguished gentleman. Woof. Well, we're not going to insult the man's looks. Come on. That's beneath us. J-Lo for $4.99.
How do you say he looks like a hobo? Well, like a homeless person.
That's his look. That's what they all look like now. I used to feel sorry for Eric and wanted you guys TBF to him, but now I think Vito was right all along. Much love, fellas. Keep up the great show. Cots for 10. When discussing complex issues like Eric July's wonderfully composed comic, it's crucial, TBF, with your approach to the... shut up. You're all terrible at this.
Yeah, it's like Cots an SAT for five. Question.
Yeah, come on. Also, the basis of my attempt was CHBT, so F off. If Vito doesn't F up, take my money. Yeah, your attempt was terrible and it did not work. Wet Bandit for 10. Tardy drink refills remind me of a waitress that served me a drink with no ice because it comes out cold, as if the drink won't immediately warm up to room temp. She was tardy, all right. No
fucking
ice
women
in the drink. Greedo fail for two. Eric July. Eric do cry. J Lo for two. Please tell him Isom sucks to his face and film it.
Yeah, if anyone sees Eric July at the Comic Con, go up and say, hey, I'm a huge fan. Psych, your comic sucks. And record that. Show, yeah. But you have to say the compliment first.
P90X plus DVD for five. Follow up.
I'll give you a Shawnee's NFT if you do that.
Ooh, a free Shawnee's NFT if you insult Eric July. On camera. He says, I pictured an older black man that was a 40-year-old comic veteran. This is Yeah, did you picture a guy who looks like he, you know, thinks a lot and is like introspective and
Thomas
has a lot
Sowell
of...
Thomas Sowell on the poster behind him. Sowell, Thomas Sowell.
What do you think of famous writers? Do you think of, you know, guys who just are out there picking fights and yelling all the time? Or do you think of quiet, introspective weirdos like me? Super Killer now available on Indiegogo. Check it out at superkiller.org. Rev for five. Be careful when you pull up to Eric July's comic book convention. He might bounce off a wall at you, as is ISM's most powerful power. Clap 99 for 10. I really think it did make that money, but people wanted to support a black anti-woke creator, and that's why so many people bought it to own the libs. We've been owned, folks. The libs have been owned. P90X for two. My brother already made his money. Why he's so mad? Jarek Juneteenth for two. Pull up. Push up, sit up, stop hiding. Geartooth Cartoons for five. Let's get a tag team match. Eric and Isom versus Vito and Derek Superkiller Chauvin. No. To determine Isom number one's quality. Rev for five. The reason he's so mad is he realized he will never make another $3 million campaign again, and his Isom number two numbers won't be even close. I'm interested to see how well it does. I don't know. How long does the anti-woke marketing gimmick last? At what point do people run out of money for anti-woke chocolate and
beer?
Well,
the economy sucks now.
Yeah.
And there's like a lot of people in the anti-woke grift game now.
Oh, they're all fighting over the same slice of the anti-woke pie.
And he's like cranking out a bunch of comics like at the same time, like one after another.
He's got three comics coming out. So rather than take the time to learn how to write one of them, he's making three. At least he's hiring other people to write them. With the cat, Kara Fro for $1.49 with a nice, beautiful picture of a cat. Thank you, Kara. The Real Hydro PX for five. Vito, when will we go to Hedonism 2? Nick Ricada's favorite swinger resort. I'd be down. That sounds fun.
Yeah, I'd go there.
I want to go on a cruise. Claptrap to the Destroyer for five. Buster Masterson spitting facts. Faho Gods for two. Scott Adams versus Eric July. When? I'd like to see that in this section of. Let's. How would that play out, I wonder?
Oh.
Oh,
well,
Scott.
Did Eric July even have 3/5 of a plot in his story?
Okay, Scott, come on. That's terrible.
Oh, maybe Isom could solve the mystery of where did the fried chicken go.
Oh, Scott. You just got canceled. You got to ease up on this stuff. You can't go full into this humor.
Oh, wow. Oh, boy. A city with no bicycles, right?
Is that what you got out of ISOM?
Yeah, that's what I got, right?
What'd you think about watching, you know, a black man fight another black man in the parking lot?
I thought, where is this, Oakland? Huh? Come on. I paid $35 to see this. I could just watch
just look out my window.
TikTok for free. You know what I'm saying, Vito?
All right, Scott. Well, I think you should support an independent black creator like Eric July. You know, he's clearly doing a lot for the black community.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
How?
Well, you know, they've been devoid. They've been devoid of such great black heroes, and he's finally delivering, you know, an anti-woke, an anti-woke hero.
He's inspiring young black men to not read, right?
He made it bad on purpose.
Wow,
so they stay away from books. That Scott Adams is a card. I tell you what. Jarek Dude, see it's for two. Where's your Ripaverse cap? I don't know. I think it's in my car. H-Punch for 10. A lot of woke media is also just bad because they're vanity projects and cram their morals into stories ham-fistedly. I mean, it's a guy living on a farm in, like, away from the city. I'm like, I know you're a libertarian. You don't want to deal with people. I get it.
Yeah, he has a whole farm. That's like the most dealing with, like, that's the most government subsidies you could have.
That's true.
Being a farm.
And he's got that big picture of him at the end wearing his taxation is theft hat. I go, you know what else is theft? Ask people to pay $45 for this. Yeah, it's terrible.
My girlfriend read it too. You know what the weird thing was? Is she's reading it and she's like saying things every single one of my notes. She's like, why the fuck would this be? Like, I'm like, I don't want
to. I'm not going
to
interrupt
you. Wait to read the notes afterwards.
They're ditching laughs for grasps because they want respect. Well, that's what it is, folks. Yeah. Jarek, Juneteenth, five Australian Jar Jar Binks was as hated as he was. He did not ruin Star Wars as completely as the sequels. Poor writing is the problem. Yes. TBF for two. So close. LOL. Great show. Not close. No. Great show, guys. Don't kill yourselves. DJ for 20 Australian. Get John Zerka on. It's hard to get that guy. He's a busy guy. We'd love to get him on.
He came on my show.
He's
crazy.
He's hard to get back. I think he's doing everything.
He's very famous now.
Goldilocks for $9.99. I'll join Vito in the weight loss. I weigh almost 240. If I can't drop before 200, before Vito loses his weight, I'll buy the biggest tier for your comic and even gift it to someone else as well. Wow.
Buy it first and then charge back if you lose the weight.
No, don't do a charge back.
Do a refund if you lose the weight. No,
I think it would be a charge back.
Buy it first.
Yeah, buy it first. Come on, vids, for $9.99. The snail population is growing. Oh, God damn it. There were more snails counted in the state of Arizona than the previously known amount. Snails coming out of coolers and suitcases.
That's true. Snails.
No.
Snails could be, they could be live snails or they could just be shells lying around. Like, you don't know. You could have a ton of snails.
If
they could
we
be
end
on the
up
roof.
Being a Rumble exclusive show, I'm going to blow my brains out.
I'm just,
and it's going to be your fault.
How are you not supposed to talk about snails?
I don't know, but you need to figure out how to not talk about snails. I'm sure you can think of a way. Stop looking around for help. Just stop it. Jesus fucking Christ. Tipster is here. I don't know if that's the real Tipster.
How can you tell?
I don't know. You got to go to his channel. There's a lot of fake Tipsters, though.
That's the real
Tipster.
The real Tipster.
What's up, Tipster?
Man?
I told Tipster he's got to come on the show. He lives in California.
Yeah, come on the show.
Tipster says, gotta love when you're living rent-free in people's heads like that. People are obsessed. Oh, I know all about that. And Tipster is also living a lot of people's heads rent-free this week. So
yeah, it's a good review.
It's a good review. It means that you've made an impact on the world. Alex Poop for $10. Don't laugh at that. That's terrible. I call my girl Sneeze because that gazoon tight. That's pretty good. Rex Sexton for 10. Vito, school choices. Okay, I don't care. Thanks for the $10. There. I'm not reading any of that. I don't care. If you like try to lecture me on a political issue with your super chat, I'm just not going to read it. I don't care. Finally, Ethan Van Schiver, comic artist pro secrets for a big $20, says, please review Cyberfrog.
Yes, send
I
it.
Will send a PDF.
I'll review
Cheers.
Anything. Send it.
A Dick will review it. Ray J for 5. Eric July's right. I'm tired of seeing your two beef. Okay, you're doing the beef one. I know.
Air
out your problems. You almost got me. Guys, biggest problem that show. Vote on all the problems. Bonus episode, biggest problem in Spider-Man will be coming soon, early next week. put up the list of our supporters, which I did not update because I didn't have time, but it will be updated on the next show. We love you all. Not that one. That's for crying only. there it is. We love you all. Thank you so much for forming a parasocial relationship with all of us. And we will be back next week with more exciting problems.
Why would you draw like so it's like a cock.
Yeah.
Like a whole full body, like that you're looking at it.
Well, because like, you like, draw a cylinder, like a cylinder is a basic shape, and then eventually it just kind of becomes
a
penis.
Lower body around the cock that
you drew. Well, once you draw the penis, why would you not draw the legs and the feet and the rest of it?
Because I'm straight. I don't want to, if I'm drawing disembodied cocks, they're like.
Just cocks.
It's like the concept of a cock that I'm drawing. It's like
so the problem is that I added the legs.
You're
to
drawing
it.
A guy, like you're drawing an actual guy.
You want disembodied cock, once an actual
it's
body.
No longer a metaphor. Now it's like a physical man.
I was just doodling. It's just what I'm just here with the pen, and the pen does what it wants. I'm an artist.
I don't know, man. This is like a reverse mermaid that I'm looking at, like with the fish head and the pussy lower body.
Okay,
that's the level of comfort I'm having from this.
You don't have to look at it. You can throw it out. It's just my notes. I drew a dick on it, and it's not a big deal.
Yeah, but you're just drawing it like out in the open. Like these teachers talking about their
relationships with
a
the kids.
A kid could come in here.
All right. Well, I would be a terrible teacher because I'd probably be doodling dicks all the time.
All right. Goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye. Ugh.